live from Arizona Stadium in Tucson, Arizona. It's Lobo Football. The University of New Mexico Lobos take on the University of Arizona Wildcats of the Pacific 10 Conference. Lobo Football on Channel 14 is brought to you in part by Coors, the beer with a difference worth tasting. Coors is the one. Coors Light, the silver bullet. There's no slowing down with the silver bullet. Ajax Mobile Home, they've got the spirit and it shows. Safeway, America's favorite food store. And by American Toyota, New Mexico's number one Toyota dealership.
Hello, everybody, and a welcome good evening to you. We're here at Arizona Stadium in Tucson, Arizona, where tonight the University of Lobos, University of Arizona, this will be the first meeting on the 77. Jim Law will Well, it is.
In this New Arizona World Conference earlier of the WAC Conference. So, yes, indeed. And the Kit Carson rifle is very important to these two schools.
Arizona's big and they're physical. So the Lobo offense, quarterback Barry Garrison and Terrence Mathis, they've got to move the football and keep the Lobo defense off the field so Arizona can't wear them down.
You're very right. But Arizona's defense knows that as well. They know that the two offensive guns for UNM are Barry Garrison and Terrence Mathis, who is right now the number one all-purpose yardage player in the United States. So that's who they'll be trying to stop.
Dick Toomey is the new head coach at Arizona, and he has a new offensive coordinator. Lobo fans are familiar with him, Ben Griffith. They run the run and shoot. Tell us about the offense of the Wildcats.
Well, Lobo fans have seen this for the last couple of years, but the Arizona fans in the first ball game last week against Iowa wanted to see more passing. And I believe that that we'll see a lot of running out of the wishbone because they know, Ben knows that the successes that Utah and New Mexico State had running the ball inside against the New Mexico defense, especially in the second half. So I look for more of that.
The Lobos pull an upset here in 75. How do they do it again?
To do it this time, they're going to have to establish a couple of long drives early where they gain confidence with ball possession. I think that's the key.
We're just about ready to go with the 61st meeting between the University of New Mexico and the University of Arizona Wildcats. It should be a good one. The Lobos are trying to bounce back. So are the Arizona Wildcats. The 61st meeting, everybody's all geared up and ready to go as you're going to see a passing offense against a ball club, Arizona, who might want to run it against the Lobos and churn up some clock time. Stay tuned now. Up and coming, it's the New Mexico Lobos and the University of Arizona Wildcats. The kickoff coming up in just one moment. We're back at Arizona Stadium in Tucson, Arizona. Jim Lawwill here along with Gary Ness. The Lobos won the toss, but they elect to kick off. And the Arizona Wildcats receive the kick. They have back deep a real speedster and number 82, and watch him tonight, Derek Hill along with Chuck Cecil. Here's the kick by Albrecht into the end zone, and it will be down in the end zone by Derek Hill. And the Wildcats will bring it out to their own 20 to start the football game. The Wildcats will be going from left to right on your television screen. There's the Wildcats on offense, Gary.
Offensive line, there are some awfully big people there. Bobby Waters, the quarterback, is a transfer. He was the starter at SMU.
There's those wide receivers. Fairholm and Hill both can fly. An offense that Lobo fans are familiar with, Ben Griffith, the offensive coordinator now at Arizona. Waters came in from SMU. Here's the option play, and they go wide with it to Greathouse, and he muscles out to about the 29, maybe the 30-yard line. He's close to a first and 10. Kirk Allen and a host of other Lobos over to make the stop. That's a good first down play for the Wildcats. Now the Lobos on defense, Gary, and that's they don't have a lot of depth to the Lobos.
Well, and losing Fred Mady in that defensive front makes them thinner yet.
We'll see five D-backs for the Lobos as well sometimes, and Danny Lara will be that extra nickel man. Out of the wishbone this time, nothing doing. Boy, diving in there and making a great stop was Bobby Edwards for New Mexico. He read it perfectly, and Darryl Lewis, the freshman, was buried for a loss.
You know, this is the first game I have ever seen where Ben Griffith, as an offense coordinator, didn't go with a pass on the first play using to check how the defense uses motion adjustment. He went right with a wishbone running action, just like we predicted.
Third and three now. Arizona outside their own 27-yard line. Waters at the throttle. He's a senior. Great House with a little draw play. He muscles up. He's very close to the first down. They may be a few inches short. Hard to tell right now. Good gang tackling that time by New Mexico. Looks short, Gary.
It is short. Fourth down situation. The crowd here, you might listen, the Wildcat crowd wants them to go for it, but they're also disappointed that they didn't put the ball in the air on that first series.
The punter is Brett Holly for Arizona. The deep man, Randy Johnson, for New Mexico. Now, Mathis has been returning punts, but Johnson returned a couple of kicks last week and did a good job. Here's the kick. High spiraling kick. Fair catch, Johnson. And the Lobos start at their own 29-yard line. Good job by the Lobo defense that series.
Very good. That ought to give the Lobos a little bit of confidence. They came out and stopped the run and shoot.
All right. There's a timeout on the field. We're just underway. We'll be right back. No score. Following Brett Hawley's punt of 40 yards, the Lobos have it at their own 29. There's that offensive line. McKay added in there this week at one tackle. In motion, that's Al Owens. And Garrison will throw right away. Looking downfield. Complete. Owens grabs it at the 40-yard line. Should be first and 10. Eugene Hardy with a stop for the Wildcats.
And no blue shirts around Barry Garrison. The offensive line afforded perfect protection. Barry had all the time he needed and got it right to Al Owens.
In case you were wondering, a score that is of interest. Utah beat Wisconsin today, 31-28 at Wisconsin. Running play, Shane Hall, nothing doing. They stack him up. It was Blake Custer leading the way that time. Second and long for New Mexico. Gary, that tells you Utah is a pretty good football team. They're 2-1 now.
Well, yes, indeed. And I have to wonder if we could see some of that vacillation offense that we saw. I wonder how much of that was used this afternoon.
Wildcats on defense. And they have got some great athletes. Second and 10 for Garrison, the senior quarterback. Second and a whack in passing coming in, dumps it to Hall. They get a couple, and that'll be it for New Mexico. Jerry Beasley, a 6'2", 229-pound linebacker, came in with a crushing tackle of Shane Hall.
A man who will be very important to Arizona's defense is their All-American candidate, Chuck Cecil, number 6 there, just walked out of the left of your picture. He's an All-American free safety, and he'll be hounding receivers tonight.
Third and 8 for the Lobos. Hall is the lone running back. Garrison flips it out to Mathis. Mathis stutter step across the 45 and drop there, very short of the first and 10. James DeBoe and a host of Wildcats came closing in on Mathis, who probably got a little more than he should have.
Fourth and 5 from the Lobo 45.
You know, those plays, those quick screens out in the flat, if you can get the first man, if you can get somebody out to block the cornerback early, that play goes for a lot. But if you don't, it's contained.
Chuck Cecil will return the punt for Arizona. You just saw him in your screen. Here's it off the side of the foot of Albrecht. Not a good punt. And it'll roll out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. The Lobos will not get much out of that. Looked like a 19-yard punt from our vantage point. We'll get the official number. A 23-yard punt. And the Lobos had an opportunity to put the Wildcats back in the hole, but the punt came up short.
If you're a golfer, that's called a shank. And Albrecht was booming them in pregame practice, but unfortunately he shanked one there.
Is that what I've been doing all these years, shanking it? I know I spend a lot of time out there. Out of the wishbone, the Wildcats. Here's Waters on the option. This time he keeps it, and he weaves his way across the 45 and dives to midfield before the Lobos bring him down. First and 10 for Arizona. Boy, leading away that time, Brett Heber for New Mexico.
The wing back, that was a sort of a lead option. Now watch the halfback there lead, and watch him turn in on the linebacker there. 82, that's Hill, Derek Hill. He gets the block that springs Bobby Waters, and Bobby shows you that foot speed.
Out of the wishbone, the Wildcats at midfield. Bobby Waters, a senior quarterback, takes the snap option. Far side of the field, dives, maybe gets a yard, and that'll be it. The Lobos read that time just the way you want to read it. Looks like the Lobos are ready for the triple option.
If you're going to defense the wishbone, you have to make sure, as in any triple option offense, you assign somebody to the dive play, the quarterback keep, and the pitch. And that you play it 1-2-3 inside out, and that's what the Lobos are effectively doing now.
I have another question about that too, Gary, after this play. And Waters brings him up this time. It's that run-and-shoot formation. You see the two slot backs, the lone running back. That's Alonzo Washington. Waters scrambling out of the pocket. Heads upfield, gets some good yardage, and dives across the 40, fumbles the ball out of bounds, and the Wildcats will keep the ball, and they've got another first down. That's just great athletic ability by Bobby Waters, who is a very good athlete.
Well, he sure is, and he's had a lot of experience running the wishbone at SMU. Now watch him as he escapes here, giving chase is, let's see, I believe that's Edwards?
Bobby Edwards.
Bobby Edwards giving chase, but and a nice peelback block by, once again, Hill, number 82. That's two plays in a row.
First and 10 Wildcats inside the Lobo 38. Again, they try the option play. This time Waters is knocked down for a loss of perhaps 2 yards. Gary, is there a certain back that maybe you want to carry the ball, so maybe you force Arizona to give the ball to that back?
Well, if I were defensing the wishbone, I would try to make the quarterback pitch the ball every time. I would try to stop the dive and the quarterback keep and make him put the ball in the air. And that's what wishbone teams don't want to do.
Second and 12. Waters has already rushed for 24 yards. They try the right side with Greathouse, and he is dumped down. Again, it doesn't look like much of a gain for the Wildcats. Kirk Allen came diving in. Funny story about Kirk Allen. He got knocked out, suffered a concussion in New Mexico State last week, and after he was hit, he came back in the defensive huddle and started calling defensive numbers that he had at Wichita State before he transferred, and all the Lobo players just looked at him and said, what are you doing?
Little deja vu.
Third and 11 for Arizona. Greathouse, the lone running back. Lewis, the freshman, in motion. Waters, stutter step, rolls right. He's going to run with it. Lobos close in. He pitches, and that's Alonzo Washington, short of a first down, just inside the 32 of New Mexico. They're going to be short. It'll be fourth down. Now, the place kicker for Arizona is Gary Costin. He missed last week.
This is the counter option. First time tonight we've seen this. They took a step to the left of the screen, then came back to the right. Didn't quite escape the pursuit, however.
Lobos did a good job of closing in on that. Waters ran that option at SMU. By saying Costin missed last week, wasn't that he wasn't healthy. He missed 2 field goals, and they hurt because the Wildcats lost to Iowa 15-14. This will be a 48-yard attempt. Hash mark to the left of your screen. Whistles everywhere. The kick up. Looks like it might be good, but there was movement in the offensive line of the Wildcats.
Dead ball foul.
It was a dead ball foul, so the play goes for naught. The kick was good, apparently. Well, the Wildcats slow to get that special teams on the field, and they were criticized last week because of mistakes like this. They're from the Pac-10. A lot of columns here in Tucson this week questioning why Arizona would play New Mexico. I believe the phrase, Gary, was the watered-down whack.
And New Mexico now employs a safety. This is a punt situation. Now you have the punt receiving specialty team up here now.
Watch for the fake, too, but they'll try to drop it in. High spiral should go into the end zone, and the Wildcats don't net much on this. Chuck Cecil was a Wildcat who caught it in the end zone. Lobos move out to their 20, so they came out of that well. That's 2 times now, the Lobo defense, although they really have no depth and are outmanned, especially weight-wise on the front, have been able to stop Arizona's sputtering run and shoot, or the wish and shoot, as they call it here. We're going to break. We'll be right back. No scores, 7:24 to go here in Tucson. Lobos start at their own 20. No score, 7:24 to go first quarter. Little draw play to Shane Hall. Tries the middle, gets a couple. That'll be it. Lobos showing a little more run in the early going than they have in previous ball games.
And that's simply to keep the defensive front honest. The defensive front, if they know you're going to retreat with the ball to pass it every time, maybe they get up on their toes and they tee off. So if they have to stop the run, look for the run. It slows down the rush.
Chris Singleton, real active on that defensive front. He does not start, but you see him a lot. 87 for Arizona. Garrison to throw over the middle, complete. That's Duff, the tight end. And he'll get about 4 yards, and Muscle maybe get another yard out of it. And the Lobos will face third and a long three or a short four. And Duff right now ranks 16th in the nation receiving passes. So of the top 20 receivers in the country, two of them play for New Mexico.
And Big John Epp represents a nice tall target. The only problem is he scares me a little bit when he gets the ball and turns upfield. He's so angular, and people take swipes at the ball, and he's been known to lose it.
The Lobos now, wide receivers to both sides as Garrison faces third and four. In the flat, complete to Tony Jones, first and 10. Riding him out of bounds for the Arizona Wildcats. A good job by Randy Kindred, who came out of nowhere. If Jones could have got past Kindred, he could have broke that for some big real estate.
And that pass was laid in there perfectly by Berry. Now watch him plant that back foot. Once again, the protection is perfect. And the ball is right over Tony's outside shoulder where he can turn up the field.
Lobos, first and 10 at their own 33. Garrison, back to pass. Over the middle, Hall again. Across the 40, and that's good second effort. He's close to a first and 10. Hall's not very big. He checks in at 5'10", 185, but his heart's pretty good sized. He showed it there.
Well, indeed it is, and you know, you plunk those over the line, over the rush, and the rush gets frustrated by it, and if you miss a tackle on the man, as such as happened right there, he ends up getting close to a first down.
Someone who will play quite a bit for the Lobos. 6-for-6 for Garrison for 32 yards, we might add. Wanted to mention for the Lobos, too, you're going to see Mike Henderson, the wide receiver, in there quite a bit in this ball game. He's seeing more and more action. But you can't do any better than Garrison, Gary. 6-for-6, 32 yards passing, well, versus Waters, who likes to run.
He's been perfect, and no one has harried him. The protection has been flawless up to this point. Dave McKay, Terrence Donaldson, Scott Maney, Barry Luther, Sam Taylor.
Second and less than a yard. Here's Hall. Cuts up field. He'll be close to the first down. The officials for tonight's game hail from the Pac-10.
That looks like a tackle trap play. Timeout here for a measurement.
Looks like it might be a little shy, but up where Gary and I are, everybody pretty much looks like an ant from our angle.
We are very high.
The attack of the killer ants, I guess, would be the phrase for it. Just inches short, as you can see on your screen there. Shane Hall, 3 rushes, 3 yards, but he's caught a couple of passes.
In this,
third and inches.
There are the officials from the Pac-10 as we've put them on the screen.
Springer, McCullough, Highsmith, and Carlson, and there's a few others.
In this situation, look for a quarterback sneak. You only have to, if the quarterback can lean forward, if the center and the two guards can just get off and the quarterback lean forward, he gets it.
He's got it. He just rode Scott Maney that time and got to compliment the Lobos center that time. Maney, as centers go for Division I football, is not that big at 6'3", 260, certainly not small. But in college football, so many times, you see a guy 6'3", 260, they say, he's not very big.
That's right.
But they are big. You take a look at them from my angle. First and 10 Lobos at their own 45-yard line. Garrison, the senior quarterback, back to throw. Time in the flat, complete and dropped. Oh, my goodness. And there's a penalty, a late hit by the Wildcats. That'll be a big break for the Lobos. Al Owens had it and dropped it. And coming over was Randy Kindred, and he came in with a late hit. That'll hurt the Wildcats. That's the kind of mistake they made last week when Iowa beat them 15-14.
He came in late, and he came to the head and the ball had already been, the play had already been stopped. Now watch this. There is no question about that.
The Lobos have four first downs, two of them by the run, two of them via the pass. Four first downs on this drive, I should say. And they've spread it out very nicely. So many times in football, a penalty like that helps a team sustain that 80-yard drive to score a touchdown.
And we talked earlier about the sustaining a drive and gaining confidence, and it appears that, like, that's just what Barry and his crew are doing right now.
Garrison outside the Arizona 40. First and 10. Here's Hall. Gets a couple. That'll be it. Boy, they really swarmed all over him. About six Wildcats came in to swarm on Shane Hall. Second down and 8 for the Lobos. Gary, how can the Lobos have that good game at Utah and lose in the last minutes of the game, really struggle at New Mexico State, and come out here against a team that some considered a top 20 team coming out of training before the preseason, and play like they have played?
Well, I wish I had a good answer for that, Jim, but it's attention to detail right now. They've been playing flawlessly.
Second and 8 for Garrison. Wants to throw. Will. Over the middle, incomplete. Mathis had it in his hands and dropped it. He had three men around him, and Garrison found a way, found an alley to get it to Terrence, but the ball was dropped.
Once again, now the protection is good. It might have been slightly touched. It might have been deflected at the line of scrimmage. But it got there anyway.
Deflected means defected.
Defective, right.
That's right. All right, third down, and we'll call it 8 yards to go for the Lobos. A big third down play for New Mexico. No score, 4:26 to go in the first quarter. You talk to Mike Shepherd and the Lobo coaches, they said, let's just stay close. Let's have a shot at them. Thus far, that's been the story. Garrison with time. Now hurried. Scrambles. Up the field, breaks a tackle. First and 10 is Garrison. Dives to the 25, and then a penalty marker is dropped. The officials will sort it out.
Garrison.
Boy, Garrison made something out of nothing there.
He
what
sure
a fine
did.
Play.
It was a good decision. I'm pretty sure who the clip was called on, John Duff, but I'd sure like to see it again.
They'll talk it over. Is this a case where you have the first and 10? And then the penalty?
Yes, because it was thrown right in the area that he gets to. Now, let's see if John Duff, from the left of your screen, number 84. No, we couldn't see it from that ground level.
Well, they back it up now to the Lobo 43. Penalties hurt. No doubt about that. Well, it will be third and 13, so they don't get the first down. The clip was obvious, as Gary pointed out. Changes personnel-wise for the Lobos. Scott Howard, you see him coming off the field. Mathis will go to the bottom of your screen. Owens to the top. Garrison with Hall as running back. Jones is flanked to the bottom of your screen as well. Garrison, third and 13, and there's movement on the line, and hankies fly everywhere. There's the UNM band right there. They made this trip. This will be the only road trip they get to make this year, and they really helped root on the Lobos.
It was sure good to hear them play the fight song, and I'm sure and they're sitting right behind the Lobos bench, so I'm sure it's inspiring to them to have them here tonight.
The Lobos are going in reverse. It'll be third down and 18 now. Two penalties on the drive. Cost him 20 yards. Garrison, third and 18. He's got all day. Now he scrambles. Now he fires. Complete to Hall, who will be dropped at the 40-yard line. That won't be enough. They get about 8. It'll be fourth down. But the Lobos will have an opportunity to pump the ball and drop the Wildcats deep in their own territory.
Now, the Wildcats elected defensively to keep people back in cover and not rush as many. They had, so you see, whoever catches the ball, there'll be a lot of blue shirts coming to the picture immediately, as did on Shane Hall there.
Jerry Beasley led the way for Arizona that time. He's a very active linebacker, and you'll see him a lot. Rick Walsh. No, check it. It'll be Steve Albrecht to try a 56-yard field goal. There it is, on the way, and it'll fall short and to the right of the goalpost. And that'll move it out to the 20 for the Arizona Wildcats. Still no score. 2:51 to go in the first quarter. New Mexico nothing. Arizona nothing. Wildcats have it when we come back. Stay with us, won't you? And here's the counter play to Art Greyhouse. And the Wildcats get a first down and more as Greyhouse does a little tiptoeing down the sideline and will finally be dropped by the Lobos at the 35-yard line. So the Wildcats come out after the missed field goal and pick up a great deal of real estate, moving it from their 38 to the 35 of New Mexico.
All right, the outstanding player for Arizona is number 82, Derek Hill. Let's watch his block down here on the cornerback. It's Hill who's fighting in there. You see that? That gives him a lot more yardage.
All right, Wildcats trying to move it. Waters on the option, spins and dives for 3 yards, maybe four. That will be it. Greathouse, 26-yard run that time. He's got 36 yards rushing, and Waters has 34. So, as you predicted, Gary, the Wildcats are moving the football, and they're going via the ground attack.
In fact, they have yet to throw a pass, and the first quarter is almost over.
Second down, a long six. Arizona at the 32 of the Lobos. Waters, counter to Darrell Lewis. Lewis converged upon and ridden back after he got to the 29-yard line. Lobos read that ball well, or the football well, and it was Brett Heber who stayed home and led the way for New Mexico.
That was the mirror of the play that was run to the near sideline two plays ago. Tried it to the other side. If it works, do it again. But the Lobos were up on the line of scrimmage to stop that reverse.
Third down and four at the Lobo 29 for Arizona.
Jim
Bobby Waters.
Will we see the first pass? This is the place for it right here.
Out of the run and shoot formation. Lewis in motion, now counters the other one. Waters, little stutter step, quarterback draw. He didn't get the first down. Again, the Lobos converge in quickly. And leading the way defensively for New Mexico was Torrey Edwards, and that's one of the biggest tackles of the ball game thus far.
Waters wanted to sprint out to get outside of Torrey Edwards where he can come out and pass run option, but Torrey made him, forced him back in off tackle. The pursuit caught him, and now once again they face a field goal situation.
This one will be a 44-yard attempt for Gary Koston. The sidewinder. Almost in the middle of the field. There's the kick. Looks like it might be short. Got over. It's good. Just got over the crossbar. And the Wildcats lead it 3-0. 44 yards on the field goal, Gary, and looked like it would be short. Just got over the crossbar.
You know, it's amazing to me that they haven't done any of the shoot out of the run and shoot yet. They haven't put the ball in the air. The biggest play has been that one reverse, which really set up that field goal there, and long one as it was.
It's become quite obvious that Arizona, Dick Toomey and Ben Griffith, both feel that they're bigger and stronger, and that they want to move the football on the ground. Don't forget that next Saturday, the Lobos will be at home when they take on the tough BYU Cougars. Join us for same-day coverage starting at 10 here on your Lobo Sports Station, KGSW TV 14. Gary and I are looking forward to seeing the air attack of BYU, and it'll be the Lobos' first home game, and I know a lot of the fans will look forward to see the Lobos. Five plays, 61 yards, and 2 minutes and 11 seconds. The Wildcats had the football before Gary Koston's field goal of 44 yards put the Wildcats ahead. 3-0. All things considered, a good quarter thus far for the Lobos, but they're going to have to get some points on the board.
Yeah, the Lobos have actually had as much offense as the Wildcats have, but they've made their one field goal attempt, and the Lobos haven't. That's the difference thus in the game.
Gary Koston tees it up. Back deep for the Lobos. Terrence Mathis, as well as Shane Hall. They kick towards Mathis at the 8. 15 and dropped a crushing tackle at the 17-yard line. Great special teams play by Arizona, and that always lifts up a football team.
Well, it sure does, and there's the dramatics and the ritual there. But this is the Lobos' worst field position. It's the first time they've had the ball inside their own 20-yard line, but they should have confidence. Now, that was the one man who got through the wedge there, and he got a good shot on Terrence Mathis.
It was Kevin Singleton. That was a crushing tackle. First and 10 for the Lobos. A pair of running backs in the backfield for Barry Garrison. Here's Mathis on a draw, and he'll lose a couple back at the 15. The Wildcats acted like they knew what the play was coming out of the huddle. Blake Custer, and he led a cluster of Wildcat tacklers.
Once again, the Lobos are trying to keep that line of scrimmage honest. There's that Wildcat drive. Five plays, 44-yard field goal. Don't have to drive very far if you can kick a 44-yard field goal.
Garrison, second and 12, back to throw. Complete to Mathis, who dives across the 25. He's close to a first down at the 28-yard line. Equipment flew around, and the helmet of Mathis, as well as what looked to be a knee pad of a Wildcat player. So,
is Mathis tough? He just, 2 plays ago, he just took that tremendous hit on returning the kickoff, and look at what he gets here, and watch him pop right up.
It's tough going when you don't have the headgear on. That's a first and 10 for New Mexico, and that's the end of the first quarter. After one quarter of play, your score, the University of Arizona 3, the University of New Mexico nothing. Now we'll be right back with the second quarter of action, so don't go anywhere. Stay wide with us now, won't you? Here's Shane Hall on the first and 10 play, and Hall gets out to around the 34-yard line. A good gainer for the Lobos of 6 yards. James DeBoe with a stop in the secondary. This is just what the Lobos need to do, is establish a drive.
Yes, it is, but the umpire threw a flag, and that means there was probably holding on the line of scrimmage, and that's what's been indicated. The Lobos haven't helped themselves by committing some errors here and by the way of penalties.
Garrison is off to a good start tonight. He is 8 of 9 passing for 52 yards thus far in the contest. I want to remind you Lobo fans that for the latest in UNM athletics, call the Lobo Sports Hotline at 277-0644 24 hours a day. So the Lobos face a first and 20, backed up to their own 18-yard line. Penalties have hurt New Mexico thus far. Garrison to throw. Lots of time. Now he's sacked. Buried at the 9-yard line. Lobos will be looking at second down and 29 yards to go now. Ajax Mobile Homes and KGSW TV 14 team up to bring you Lobo football. Ajax Mobile Homes, they've got the spirit, and it shows. Well, they moved it to the 10, Gary. It's second and 28 now. Not an ideal situation to find yourself in.
No, it isn't. But what you do is you've got to use 2 downs to get this. Don't try to get it all right here.
Garrison, a little draw play. Shane Hall will dive to the 15. The Lobos get 5 back.
4 yards on the carry. Third and 24 at the 14.
Lobos want to be careful here, too. They trail it 3-0, but they certainly don't want a turnover at this point. Scott Howard checks in for New Mexico.
A safe play in this at this part of the field would be a screen pass, and it's a potential big gainer, but it's a short throw. Let's see if they haven't shown a screen yet tonight. This would be a place for them.
Garrison, little quick kick from Shane Hall, and he doesn't kick it very well, and it's fumbled by the Wildcats, and it looks like John Duff has it for New Mexico. That is a great break for the Lobos, and Duff, right place, right time.
John Duff was there in the right place for the right time, but that was a great decision. Look at this, folks. You don't see this in college football very often. Shane Hall on the run, quick kick quick punch, you might say, and look at that recovery.
I'll tell you a funny story in practice with the Lobos. They were running at play, and Hall kicked the ball so low he hit Maney in the back, the center. And that one was pretty low, too, but it worked out perfectly as Arizona tried to field the ball on a quick hop, and Duff was right there. He took the carom. What a break for New Mexico. It's the kind of luck you need. Garrison to throw, looking downfield. We'll see if he caught it. The intended receiver on the sideline was Al Owens. Was in his hands and then got away. Second and 10 for New Mexico. Those are the kind of passes the Lobos will have to catch to move the football against the Wildcats.
Yes, they will. But the encouraging thing is that front line, Art Valero's crew there, is doing a flawless job of protecting Barry Garrison.
And this is an Arizona front that is big and strong. 274, 261, 259. Garrison, a running play to Tony Jones. And Jones gets about 3 yards. Wildcats on piling. Dana Wells led the way. Nose guard. He's near 261 pounds.
The Arizona defense had a blitz on them. A lot of men at the line of scrimmage. Had that play broken at the line of scrimmage, there was no safety to catch the man. That would have been a long, long gainer.
Third and a long six for New Mexico. 12:38 and counting, remaining first half. If you just joined us, Arizona leads 3-0. Lobos trying to put together a drive. Here's Garrison, and he's sacked. At the 35-yard line, Chuck Cecil, the free safety, in on a blitz.
They did it two plays in a row. Cecil crept up and rushed off the right corner as your screen. And watch him from the top of your screen, number six. He's an extra man there. He got by Terrence Donaldson's block. He just kind of ducked under him for the sack.
Albrecht with a punt. It's a beauty. There's Derek Hill on the run. 30, 35. There he goes. Boy, can he fly. 40, 35, and finally dropped inside the 25 of New Mexico. We talked about Derek Hill. He can really go. We'll be right back in just a moment. 3-0, Arizona. We're back. Waters into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Derek Hill returns a punt 46 yards and then catches the touchdown pass from Waters. 9-0, Arizona.
Well, they picked a good one for their first pass of the day. Derek Hill crosses the field against man-for-man coverage. Now, the important thing here is that Bobby Waters has a lot of time. Look at him. You can even count there. He's had four, almost 5 seconds to release the ball. Across the middle, just inside the goal line, Derek Hill.
Coaston's extra point is good. So the teams are heading up the field. 11:45 to go in the first half. Arizona 10, New Mexico nothing. The Lobos need a drive when we get back. And here's the touchdown pass from Waters to Derek Hill.
Fake the fear at the first step back. He's really only 5 yards deep in the pocket, but he had all the time necessary. Brad Heber trying to cover Derek Hill man for man that's an impossible job. Derek Hill has Olympic sprinter speed.
He certainly does. There's the drive. Started on the 25 after the 46-yard punt return by Derek Hill. Special teams and penalties. That's why the Lobos trail 10-0. Here's the kickoff. Mathis at the 3 to bring it up. Gets the seam. Mathis to the 30 and the 31-yard line. The Lobos will have some room to operate. They must move the football now.
You are so correct. They must now to swing momentum back their way as we see Terrence. Now watch him run up through the wedge. Right there.
28-yard return.
Almost breaking it.
Terrence is out of Stone Mountain, Georgia. Ever been to Stone Mountain? That's quite a climb. That'll make you quick. Go up and down that baby a couple of times. Garrison ready at his own 31. Hash mark to the bottom of your screen. Little swing pass to Mathis. Starts up the field, gets some running room. He's all the way out to the 46-yard line. Good gainer for the Lobos. Well, they showed us Arizona put Derek Hill. They put him out for people to get to watch him, and now the Lobos are putting Mathis out for a little exhibition.
And watch Mathis move right here on Chuck Cecil. They're All-American. Ran right by Cecil, but the strong safety came over to make the tackle.
At the Lobo 46, here's Garrison. Scott Howard, the St. Pius product, is a running back. Garrison to throw. Dumps it off, dropped. They had the screen set up to perfection, but Scott Howard was apprehensive. He wanted to get the ball and go, and he didn't take time to look the ball into your hands. So many times the coaches tell you, catch the ball first.
It was set up so beautifully, and watch the people. Well, you can't quite see them in the screen, the people in front to block, but all of us have done that. You know, sometimes the most difficult one to catch is the one that's right there.
How many times do you see in baseball the changeup strike out so many great hitters? It's not that 95-mile-an-hour fastball. Terrence Mathis, two receptions, 26 yards thus far tonight. Boy, we've got a great statistician and spotter helping us tonight. Here's Garrison to throw. Complete. Nice curl-in pattern for Mike Henderson. James DeBoe on the stop. So the freshman makes himself heard.
And that was some throw by number 11, Garrison. He really wanted to go to Mathis, who was the outside receiver, but he saw the double coverage on him and went inside to Henderson. Nice catch by Henderson, a true freshman.
Third and less than a yard. You know, Garrison told me in a feature that we'll run at halftime, and it will be seen on the coaches' show tomorrow at 11, the Mike Shepherd show as well. Now, when he was El Dorado, he sometimes dreamt of being the quarterback at the University of New Mexico. Hall gets the first down. First and 10 Lobos in Wildcat territory. They expected 48,000. It looks like they have that much, Gary. It's a good crowd, and Tucson has really supported Arizona football and basketball.
They have, and the story we hear is that they're going to expand the stadium further here.
We're up in the nosebleed land, but we may be higher next time we come here, because they're going to build a deck atop where we are. Garrison ready. First and 10 at the 43 of Arizona. Lots of time to throw. Downfield, looking for Mathis. Incomplete. Mathis broke free, but the ball was thrown wide. On the coverage was Randy Kindred for the University of Arizona.
But lest we ignore this, the ball was thrown safely. Yes, it was thrown a little bit wide, but it was thrown where it could not be intercepted.
The Lobos have 9 first downs to Arizona's 3, but they trail 10-0. The Lobos missed a field goal. Arizona kicked theirs. And then the 46-yard punt return created the touchdown pass from Waters to Hill from 25 yards out. 10:03 to go first half. Lobos on the move. Garrison to throw with time again. Complete to Hall. He should get a first down, and he will, as he puts his head down and dives to the 30 of Arizona. The Lobos get on the board here, especially a touchdown, and they're right back in the football game.
You saw Garrison give a pass there to Shane Hall. Now, every time they double cover the wide receivers, this is a hot receiver pattern. Shane Hall sees that the linebackers are moving out on the wide receivers, and he just curls the middle and looks for the throw from Barry, and Barry's looking for the same cue. Good coaching there.
Here comes Garrison. Here come the Lobos to the bottom of your screen. Mathis, top of your screen. Owens along with Tony Jones. A running play to Hall weaves his way to the 26-yard line. A good gain of 4. It'll be 2nd and 6 for the Lobos. Chris Singleton, the sophomore, made the tackle for Arizona.
And no one can say at this point, you know, we don't know what the time of possession is, but the Lobos have had the ball much more than the Wildcats have in this half. Unfortunately, however, for the Lobos, they have nothing to show for it on the scoreboard.
Penalties, a breakdown in special teams, and a field goal kicked when the Lobos fell short. The one by the Wildcats just got over the crossbar. Another running play for Hall. He finds a little room and gets to the 24, maybe the 23. Looks like they're going to move it back to the 24, so only a couple of yards. It'll be Third and four New Mexico. Jerry Beasley with another tackle. We've called his name a lot. He wears number 43 for Arizona. He calls the defensive signals for the Wildcats.
And this is where defenses tend to toughen up. When you get around a team's own 20-yard line, it gets very tough here. The Lobos, however, are in two-down territory. It's third and four, but they have two downs to make it here.
Garrison to throw with time. Over the middle to Mathis. Gets the first down, breaks it outside. Terrick to the 10 and dives to the 7-yard line of Arizona. He's out of bounds. He'll stop the clock. It'll be first and goal for New Mexico. Gary, what did they do? Because they really broke Mathis open wide where he could show that great acceleration.
He ran right across the field from right to left on your screen about 5 yards into the secondary. That's all. He's running underneath the coverage. And Barry drops it to him. Now watch him accelerate right here. Just accelerate behind the linebacker. Now, if Scott Howard, number 26 in your picture, can just find somebody right there. Scott, if he could have gotten ahead of Terry, he might have got into the end zone.
First and goal at the 7. There's Scott Howard, and he maybe gets to inside the 6. Wildcats stack it up well. It was a good play calling. Good play calling, I should say, by Mike Shepard on that 3rd and 4. He pulled one out of the hat that was perfect for the situation.
Indeed it is, but the Lobos are actually making a little bit more yardage now on their runs, and in tight, in Arizona's own backyard where it's supposed to get tougher. The offensive line are rooting them out.
Garrison's having a big night thus far. 2nd and goal at the 6-yard line of Arizona. Garrison drops back, pump fakes and rolls, looking. Throws in the end zone, incomplete. No interference call, although Tony Jones hit the deck. Chuck Cecil on the coverage. It looked like perhaps Jones just fell down.
I think so. Now Barry eludes the rush. They had the blitz coming. Now he steps out of this. Now he's running to the sideline. He's looking downfield, looking in the end zone for a receiver to break open. And Tony tries to plant and come back, but you already see him on his back. It looks like from here, Jim, the Lobos will have to throw to get into the end zone. Two pass plays here.
3rd and goal to go at the 6. There's a shot from the end zone. Garrison fakes to Hall, rolls to his right. They're after him. He stops. He's in trouble. He fires it into the end zone. Picked off. The Wildcats have it. It looked like Tom Bassey was there to pick it off. No, it was Todd Burden with the interception. Todd Burden picks it off.
And John Duff makes a heck of a play to come back here and get this. If John Duff doesn't catch him, he may have a 100-yard return.
Burden picks it off. We'll be right back.
Escape to the open road.
Back at Arizona Stadium. Arizona just inside their own 5. Waters with a little counter move and stopped and dropped, but not before he carries Brian McCabe for a couple of yards with a 12, a gain of 7. Mexico with 13 plays in 4 minutes and 25 seconds. They went 69 yards, but they came up with nothing.
And there's an old adage in coaching, you want to score before 13th play, and then on the 13th play occurred the interception.
Arizona out of the wishbone. 2nd and short at their 12. Penalty marker down in the area that could be holding. That time they moved the wide receiver Derek Hill to the backfield. We were told we'd see that. Sky Hill runs a 4.5 40, so they're going to try to get him the ball as much as they can.
Well, Derek Hill has been the outstanding player of the game for Arizona Wildcats. His punt return set up the only touchdown of the game. Plus, he's thrown some great blocks and has made some receptions. In fact, he caught the touchdown pass.
He's going to go against Arizona. A break for the Lobos.
Looking forward, Jim, you can't change anything that's already occurred, but this is a big series for the Lobo defense. They have to force Arizona to punt out of their end zone.
2nd down and 9. Outside the 6-yard line of Arizona. Waters brings up the Wildcats. There's your run and shoot formation. Slot backs to each side. That's Greathouse in motion. Waters rolls to throw. Downfield, incomplete. was trying to go to Reggie McGill, but he couldn't get it to him.
And if that pass looks easy, it isn't. That's a tough pass to throw.
And Arizona 6.
We're the Lobo announcers on TV, Gary, but quite frankly, the Lobos have probably played the better football game, but they've made the mental mistakes, and they haven't been able to cash in two scoring opportunities, and sometimes that'll come back to haunt you. Third and 9, a big third down for both clubs. Greathouse in motion, Waters to throw, in trouble, fires it in the flat. Alonzo Washington will have a first down and breaks it. He'll go all the way unless Jared Douglas can catch him. Alonzo Washington, touchdown Arizona. That pass will go for 94 yards and a touchdown, and Arizona leads 16-0. Breakdown on special teams, penalties, and now the Lobos give up the big play.
The screen pass can kill you if you don't stop it at the line of scrimmage. This is executed very well. Art Martinez had turned the play back up in, but Greathouse was just too fast for the pursuit. Now there you see the dump off to Greathouse. Art Martinez, well, he got outside of Art Martinez. Thus the pursuit couldn't catch it.
Gostin's extra point is right between the uprights. Monday night at 8 from Fox, it's Werewolf the Movie. Don't miss this special two-hour encore presentation of one of the season's hottest new shows. It's Monday night at 8, right here on KGSW TV 14, your Fox station. That 94-yard touchdown pass from Waters to Alonzo Washington sets a University of Arizona record. Right when it looked like the Lobos would pin the Wildcats way back in their own territory, they broke it, and Washington went down the field. The last hope for the Lobos defensively was Darren Douglas, and he couldn't get him.
And it went for 94 yards, but the completion was actually made at just about the line of scrimmage. So he wasn't thrown very far downfield, but right now, there's no one that can catch him. In fact, he's a coaxing. You see him coaxing his blocker up in front to try to make sure that Darren Douglas doesn't make the tackle.
17-0. Arizona leads it. Coasting to kick it off. Moves it towards the end zone. Mathis takes it, and intelligently, he will down it in the end zone. The Lobos start at their own 20-yard line. 6:02 to go first half. Arizona leading 17-0. Gary, what do you do now? You've coached at the Division I level. What do the Lobos have to do?
Do just what they did their previous possession, march down the field, but you got to put it in for a touchdown. If they don't, they go into half shut out as well as they've played, even though it'll be tough to convince anybody that the Lobos have played well being down 17-0. But if they can put something on the board here, they know they're still in the game.
Mathis at his own 20-yard line, or I should say Garrison. And Garrison back to throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Shane Hall, and Shane gets 7 out of that. It'll be 2nd and 3. Blake Custer led the way for the University of Arizona. A field goal for Arizona that just got over the crossbar. Then Derek Hill, with Olympic-type speed, sprinted 46 yards on a punt return. On the next play, a 25-yard touchdown pass to Derek Hill. And then, 3rd and 9 from their own 6, Arizona throws a 94-yard touchdown pass. Here's Hall again, and gets near the first down at the 30, and then is muscled back by a host of Wildcat tacklers.
There is no reason for the Lobos to be impatient on this drive. They can do just as they're doing, throw the short pass and use the running play. They started with about 6 minutes. We're down now to near 5. But there is plenty of time to drive it in here and score.
At the 29.
Third down, less than a yard. Lobos with a pair of running backs this time. Quarterback keeper and Garrison gets across the 30, has a first down. Garrison made one big mistake with the interception he threw in the end zone that was brought out to the 6-yard line. But Garrison is 13 for 19 for 107 yards. He has one interception. .445 and counting remaining, so plenty of time for the Lobos to put together a drive, try to get on the board before halftime. The Wildcats have used the big play. They lead it 17 to nothing. Garrison ready. Back to throw. Looking deep for Mathis. He might have him. Complete and dropped. Again, the Lobos have a pass in their hands and then drop it.
That was so close. So close.
James DeBoe on the coverage.
I believe that DeBoe got a hand in there just as the ball arrived, but he had to scramble to do it because Mathis was ahead of him. Let's see. Let's see this replay. Right at the bottom right corner.
Oh, he had it, Gary, and he lost it.
You're right. You're right. It was above DeBoe.
If he hangs on to it, he stays in bounds. He's gone. So close, but so far away. Second and 10, Lobos. Garrison to throw. In the flat, tipped away. Great defensive play for the Wildcats. Keith Moody was a man who came storming in and tipped that pass away. You teach those defensive linemen when they see the ball thrown to get those big arms and hands up in the air.
But don't jump. They're not supposed to jump. Here are the stats on Barry thus far in this half. Very respectable.
Why not jump, Gary?
Well, because if you jump, once you're in the air, then the quarterback can duck under you and buy more time to get the ball away or run upfield.
First downs, look at that. Lobos 12, Wildcats 4. You say to yourself, my goodness, 17 to nothing. But it was the mistakes, and the Wildcats have cashed in on every Lobo error. Third and 10, big play for the Lobos. Garrison with time has a man complete to Mathis across the 45 to the 46. And Terrence Mathis continues his assault on the all-time receiving records at the University of New Mexico, as well as all-time all-purpose yardage.
And you saw Terrence raise his hand. He needs a blow here. He needs to catch his breath. Watch this. He gets it right in the stomach. I think the first defender may have hit him right in the stomach and knocked the wind out of him. Terrence has had a busy evening. That was a great catch on and a clutch catch on a third down play.
First and 10, Lobos. They need to get on the board. 3:55 to go first half. Garrison to throw. Complete to Thomas Crum. And Crum gets to just outside the 45 in Wildcat territory.
Now the Lobos might start glancing at the clock and start throwing wide patterns and backs to receivers in the flat so they can get out of bounds to stop it. Clock's ticking down toward 3.5 minutes, and they've crossed midfield. But as it gets down to 2, then they'll start glancing at it.
30 on your screen, Randy Kindred had the tackle, and he's had many thus far this evening. Second and short, Shane Hall dropped. He lost a yard. Boy, Keith Moody again in. That's the second time on this possession for the Lobos that he has spelled trouble, M-O-O-D-Y.
Moody got through the interior. That's one of the few times this evening that anyone has been able to get inside the tackles to make a play on the Lobo, either quarterback or running back.
Third down, a long two for New Mexico, a key play on the drive. Garrison brings up the Lobos. Two running backs behind Garrison. Back to throw, Garrison looks in the flat, incomplete. Was looking for Reggie Rogers. Over on the coverage was Jerry Beasley for Arizona.
Reggie hadn't quite looked around far enough yet for that ball. The ball was there a little bit early. Interesting situation here. Fourth down, 2 minutes 41 seconds to go. You have the ball just across midfield, and there comes the punting team. And they will kick against the regular defense of Arizona.
Rick Walsh, the place kicker, is back to punt the football. He'll look to hang it. Spirals it inside the 10. Chuck Cecil takes it to the 15, breaks tackles. Here he goes. Out to the 27, and his own man will stop him.
3-6 yards on the punt. It's an All-American play by Cecil. Now, if Cecil lets this ball go, the Lobos are there to down it at the goal line. But Cecil did not call for a fair catch, took a little bit of a risk, caught the ball on the run, got beyond that first wave of Lobo rushers, and almost broke it.
For Remember, tomorrow it'll be the Mike Shepherd Show at 11 a.m. on Channel 14. Coach will talk about the Arizona game. They'll have a feature on senior quarterback Barry Garrison. There you see it, the Mike Shepherd Show, tomorrow, 11 a.m. on the Great Entertainer.
Once again, Jim, the previous possession by the Lobos, that was a 12-play drive right there that came up with nothing. But they moved the ball, they gained field position, 12 plays for naught.
Lobo football on KGSW-TV is made possible in part by Coors Beer. Coors, the beer with a difference worth tasting. Coors is the one. So the Wildcats have 2:29 to see what they can do, leading New Mexico 17-0. Out of the wishbone, Bobby Waters pulls the Lobos offsides. It was Brian McCabe who jumped across the line of scrimmage that time.
That's an interesting call. Now Brian McCabe, unless he made contact with somebody, is allowed to get back on his side of the neutral zone.
Ronald Veal, the sophomore, is the new quarterback this series. It is not Waters. Veal wearing number 10. They were going to redshirt the youngster Veal. But what happened was the backup quarterback, Craig Bergman, who was number one in spring training before Waters transferred, quit the team earlier this week. So they couldn't redshirt Veal like they wanted to. They call him the Wildcat quarterback of the future. We're getting to watch him right now. The Wildcats, first and five. That time, Greathouse takes it on the option, and Lobos stand him up and abuse him a little bit. Couple of yards, it'll be second and three for Arizona.
And Jim, to follow up on that comment, Dick Tomey, the coach, was quoted in this morning's paper as saying Veal has more athletic ability than any of his quarterbacks. So although he's young and inexperienced, he's got some athletic ability.
Youngster is out of California, the state of California that produces so many college football players. They try the middle with Art Greathouse, and he'll dive across the 40 to the 41. Here's something Arizona has that New Mexico does not enjoy in Mike Shepherd's first year at the helm. He came in, did not have time to recruit, and many of the players, some of the talented players that were at New Mexico, were quite frankly basically run off by the previous staff, so he doesn't have depth, and Arizona can keep moving them in there. Veal, a new quarterback with a change of cadence, and the Wildcats jump off sides. That'll be first and 15.
I think it was Jeff Reinhart, the 6'2", 308-pound tackle who moved. You know, most scales of human weight stop. Look at the bottom of your screen, Reinhart. No, it's his, well, there's Reinhart and the guard both move.
908 pounds.
That's 140 kilograms. It sounds more mortal if you use the kilogram measure.
Greathouse, five rushes, 44 yards thus far. He's a sophomore out of Tempe. Dave Elridge is in motion. Here's Veal, the quarterback. A little scramble, and he'll get across the Wildcat 45 to the 46-yard line before he's dropped by New Mexico. A good first and 15 play as the Wildcats net 11 yards. It'll be second and four.
And what the Wildcats are doing, however, they show no respect for the clock. They seem content on running the ball in the middle, and of course Veal started out like he was going to throw the ball, but ended up running it.
The Lobo offense has moved the ball well enough that a 17-point deficit could be overcome. Here's Veal to throw downfield, complete. A great leaping catch that time. Pulling it down was Reggie McGill, and you can't time it any better than McGill did. And he was hit hard and managed to hang on to the football.
And here's why they are so high on Veal. Veal plants, steps up, and throws. He's not a very tall player, but he got the ball where he needed to.
The Wildcats have moved now to outside the Lobo 33-yard line. 40 seconds to go in the first half, and timeout call. A bizarre first half in many ways. Arizona leading at 17 to nothing. But Arizona, a 46-yard punt return, a quick 25-yard pass for a touchdown. They kicked a field goal of 44 yards. It barely cleared the crossbar. Start result gives you an idea. It was mistakes that they took advantage of. After the Garrison interception, then comes the 94-yard touchdown pass. Of all the things you could imagine happening from 3rd and 9 at the Wildcat 6, you don't imagine them going 94 yards with a screen pass play, but that's what happened.
Well, what Arizona hasn't done is they haven't driven down the field with a classic drive, ball possession drive, and that's what they haven't done. The Lobos, however, have three times, but have nothing to show for it. So the difference is that Arizona has been opportunistic and made the best of their opportunities, whereas the Lobos have not up to this point.
They'd like to keep the Wildcats off the board, too. 40 seconds to go in the first half. The Lobos substitute as much as they can, Gary, but they just don't have that much personnel.
No, but the defense has not been on the field that much this half. The defense shouldn't be weary in any respect.
Beal, the young quarterback, has McGill in motion. He wants to throw again downfield. Frome, complete. That's Fairholm. He was wide open, and he's all the way to the 2-yard line of New Mexico. Jeff Fairholm, who started last week, who was relegated to second team this week, makes a big reception. He's a senior wide receiver.
There has to be a breakdown in coverage here because there are five defensive backs on the field, and to be that open, somebody thought somebody else was going to cover Fairholm, who did not.
The Lobos are going to take a timeout. There are 24 seconds left in the first half. The Lobos right now are thinking, if there's any way we can adjust and stack them up and hold them to a field goal, it is so important because a touchdown makes it 24-0, and then we need four touchdowns to take the lead.
And you see, you heard the applause as well as you watched Beal go talk to Dick Tomey on his sideline. He has captured the fancy of the crowd here. He's 2 for 2 for 49 yards. But you're right, Jim. The key for the Lobos here is to keep them off the board in this situation. Even forcing them to kick a field goal in this situation would be somewhat, would be better than the touchdown. Very important defensive stand here.
You hope for a turnover if you can get one, much like the Wildcats got when it was 3rd and goal for New Mexico. At that point, 10-0, it looked like the Lobos would at least get a field goal out of that drive. But Garrison scrambling through the interception in the end zone. Then boom, the Wildcats on a 94-yard touchdown pass to go up 17-0 after the PAT, a school record. As Gary so astutely pointed out, though, the ball was thrown to the receiver at the line of scrimmage. It was a screen that they broke free on. And so now, as we rejoin the action, 1st and goal to go inside the 3-yard line. Here's Veal to Greathouse, and the Lobos stack it up well. Good job defensively by New Mexico. Art Martinez, John Bell in there on the stop.
Now the Arizona Wildcats have two timeouts to use there, and they've just used one right here.
There it is.
Kirk Allen coming over the top.
John Bell, the freshman out of Del Norte, getting some valuable experience as a freshman.
He really is. You know, I think John Bell's a good enough player that he would get the experience anyway, but with the injury to Mady, John's getting more than he probably would have. And in years ahead, John will remember these experiences, and he's growing up a lot on the field tonight.
How much does the loss of Mady for this game, and perhaps he will be back for BYU, but the loss of Mady means a lot to the Lobo defense.
Well, it does. Mady was the guy who can break through the line of scrimmage and put pressure on the quarterback, and for a while, of course, Arizona didn't try to throw the ball, and they've done it very judiciously, but very effectively. But Fred not being there hurts their pass rush.
Timeouts left, only one for Arizona. McGill, the wide receiver, like Veal, a youngster, he's a true freshman. Second and goal to go outside the one. Here's McGill, and the Lobos rack him up. Outside the goal line. So right now the Wildcats call their last timeout. 13 seconds to go in the first half. Lobos will have to stack them up one more time.
And this should be an interesting replay from the end zone. Let's look at this. Art Martinez coming over the top. Kirk Allen, 38. Martinez, 35, and Allen, 38. What a play.
Jack Stanton will call his defense over to the sideline again. You can see the cord to his headset is pulled all the way out as far as he can possibly get in there.
Now, Jim, let's assess the situation. It's third down, and they're out of timeout. So what happens if you stop Arizona here? What I think is going to happen is I think this play will be a pass play so that the clock will stop for them to either kick the field goal or get off or huddle and make another play. Otherwise, in 13 seconds, if they run the ball this down, they've got to get it in the end zone. And I think that's probably what Jack Stanton's telling his defense.
Well, the Lobos head back out to the line of scrimmage. Their backs are to the wall, inside the one. Third and goal, Arizona. 13 seconds to go in the first half.
And if I'd expound on that a little further, I would sprint out field to the right. They're on the left hash. Just look for a sprint out to the right of the field.
Here we go. Beal, the young quarterback, takes it, sprints to the right, throws in the end zone, incomplete. Boy, in there breaking that up in high fashion for New Mexico. And I mean, he came in strong, was Clay Orison. They needed to pressure Beal, and they did.
And the one thing they weren't going to do was let Beal get outside on a sprint out. So you can hear the response from the crowd. They want him to go for it. I think the Lobos want him to go for it. Shut him down here.
Well, the kicking tee heads back to the sideline. They're kind of toying with New Mexico like they feel like they can play with it a little bit. They get stopped here, though. The Lobos will be pumped up for the second half.
You're right. This could indicate a big momentum shift.
They move. The Wildcats are offside. You could see it. It was the right side of the offensive line. Lobos are very happy. Musa Kanicki pointing. He says, you guys jumped, and it was pretty obvious. It was against the Lobos, not the end of the world. It goes from 12 inches to 6.
In a way, I hate to see that because I think the Lobos would rather... Well, let's see if he got in. Let's see what happens here. So it's a dead ball foul. Ball start, so they rule the play never happened. So now the kicking tee will come on.
17-0 Arizona. Costin to attempt the field goal. These are tough, these short ones. 22 yards. The kick up. The kick is good. Well, the Lobos didn't come out of that all that badly. The field goal will go for 22 yards unofficially. We're down to 7 seconds to go in the first half. Arizona leading at 20-0. But the Lobos, who have moved the football between the 10-yard lines all night with 3 touchdowns, can take the lead in the football game. And for Arizona, who acted a bit on this drive like they were toying with the Lobos, and sometimes that's not too wise either.
No, it isn't. They showed that they were going to put it in, but the Lobos stopped them. I consider that a good goal line stand. I'm sure they're not satisfied with the way the defense played in allowing the first drive of the game for Arizona, but at the goal line, they sure toughened up.
So many times you loosen up with a less than 2 minutes to go. Defensively, you do. There's the new head coach at Arizona. 10 years at Hawaii. Takes over for Larry Smith, who has moved on to Southern Cal. Smith's baptism against Michigan State was not one of great joy.
No, they pulled one out today against Boston College, however.
73 yards, 2 minutes, 22 seconds for the field goal. The kickoff taken up by the Lobos and brought across the 32-yard line. Lobos have 2 timeouts. They might be able to get a playoff. The clock stops after the kick return anyway.
And the tackler of, I believe it was Steve Howes, who took that ball, that kickoff, the tackler for Arizona is down. There was some contact made on that.
You let those linemen get that kickoff, and they like to bring it up the field.
You bet, but it worries coaches because sometimes those linemen in their exuberance don't hang on to the ball very well.
Arizona player is down. It's 20-0 Arizona. Coming up at halftime, we have a feature on the quarterback at the University of New Mexico, Barry Garrison. We'll have all the stats. Gary and I will go through them. When you see the statistics from the first half, you're going to be totally amazed that the Lobos trail 20-0. But it's been the big play and penalties that have cost the University of New Mexico thus far. Encouraging for New Mexico, the fact that they've chewed up yardage. Just going to have to play a little more intelligently when they get that ball inside the 10-yard line.
Well, you have to wonder if the Lobos can, if they do get some breaks, such as the Wildcats have had in this first half, in the Lobos' second half, if they could capitalize on them, this game could be very close and the Lobos could be in position to win. But they're going to have to create some breaks in the second half.
It'll be a very special Sunday night tomorrow on KGSW TV 14 at 6. Don't miss the new season premiere of 21 Jump Street. And then at 7, for the first time on TV 14, it's the 39th Annual Emmy Awards. That's tomorrow night for the best in entertainment. Turn to KGSW TV 14. Mexico football is telecast on KGSW TV 14, and it's brought to you in part by Safeway. Safeway is America's favorite food store. There's your player that was down. Now the Lobos with 2 seconds.
Will we see some razzle-dazzle here?
Garrison with a running play to Tony Jones, breaks it out. He fumbles the ball, I believe, in a skirmish for it. Galen Allen knocked the ball loose for Arizona. That's the end of the first half. So a crowd of about 48,000, and the stadium pretty full with the exception of the far end zone. And there's your halftime score, 20-0. We'll be right back with you.
At halftime here at Arizona Stadium, you see the score, Arizona 20, New Mexico 0. And in the backdrop, you see the University of New Mexico marching band. One of the outstanding players for the University of New Mexico this year has been their standout senior quarterback, Barry Garrison. Jim Lowell interviewed Barry earlier this week. Here is that interview.
Behind me, the campus of El Dorado High School, and it was just 6 years ago, six football seasons ago, that Barry Garrison was a senior quarterback at El Dorado High School. Garrison then went on to the University of New Mexico. He now quarterbacks the Lobos. He had to earn his way there. It took him 4 seasons to finally become the head man of the Lobo offensive attack. Let's meet the quarterback for the University of New Mexico, Barry Garrison. Barry, did you ever dream when you were the quarterback at El Dorado High School about maybe someday being UNM's quarterback?
Well, I didn't know for sure about UNM, but I hoped I'd be a quarterback somewhere, and luckily it came true.
To say you pay your dues would be probably an understatement. You look back on it, 4 years here behind Rucker, behind Ned James, just to name a couple. What was going through your mind over those seasons?
Well, you know, you just got to work hard. You got to get, you know, you got to do your best to learn behind the people that you're, you know, when you're behind those people. And, you know, those were good people to be behind. They all played well, and they all taught me some things. And I'm glad that I hung in as long as I did and gave myself a chance. And now it is my chance, so I'm trying to do it.
You never did think maybe perhaps about transferring or anything like that?
No, I was going to go ahead and stick it out here. I didn't really have any thoughts about transferring or going anywhere else. I figured I was going to school here, I was getting my education paid for, and if this didn't work out, then it wasn't the way it was supposed to be, but fortunately it was, and I'm getting a chance.
The run and shoot probably wasn't your offense. This pro-style offense you're running with Coach Shepard is.
Yeah, it's a little more towards what I do best. I mean, I'm not real fleet-footed. I don't run real well. And, I don't have an overly powerful arm or anything like that, but I throw the ball all right, and it's more suited towards me.
The first game was a dream come true. The second game was probably just the opposite, a nightmare. So you've experienced both worlds, and you've had 2 starts for the Lobos.
Yeah, well, the first game, you know, all that was great, but we still didn't win the game. And this last week was a real big disappointment. We thought we should have went in there and won the game, and I I definitely didn't play the kind of game that I wanted to play, and the team didn't come through as like we planned, and it was a big disappointment.
We'll be back and talk a little more with Lobo quarterback Barry Garrison right after this. Let's talk a little more with Barry Garrison.
I bet the home opener versus BYU, that's coming up in a little while here. I bet you're excited about that.
Yeah, it's fun. It's always fun against play against BYU because they're a good team and they're always up there in the tops of the league. And it's exciting to play at home finally. You know, you have a bunch of games on the road and somebody you can play in front of all the people that you hear. So it's going to be fun.
The coaching change was a good one for you.
Well, yeah, I was fortunate in that aspect too. You know, it was kind of a situation where when they came in, it kind of gave me a chance, and it brought in some new attitudes and everything like that. It worked out good.
When it's third down and long, and the money's on the line, what's Barry Garrison going to do? Who are you looking for?
Well, I'm just looking to get somebody the ball, hopefully in my color jersey. We got some good people that catch a ball. You know, Terrence Mathis has done it before, and he'll do it again. But we've got other people, too, that are going to do the job.
Are you ever going to run the football very much?
Well, we haven't run the ball real good yet, but that's something that we've just got to improve on, and we will. You know, that not only helps us with the running game, but it'll get us going with the passing game, too. So I think that's something that we'll work on a lot.
We opened this feature on you, a little piece in front of El Dorado High School, and you look back on those years now, and I guess you look back on them with a lot of satisfaction.
Yeah, well, that was a long time ago, it seems like. And, yeah, it was fun to play there and go to school there, and I had a good time.
Okay, one last question. As you move on now and the season goes on, when it's all over, when you look back on it, what would you like to be able to say you accomplished?
Well, hopefully to win. I wanted to win some football games, and I think that's what everyone wants to do here. That's the name of the game, and I hope I can look back and say that I know that I'll be able to look back and say I did my best, and you know, hopefully we've got more wins than we have losses, and that's, I think, what it's all about.
How about life off the football field for Barry Garrison? What do you like to do?
Well, I'm trying to get over with school here. I want to get my degree and graduate, and I'm just looking on doing that. Hopefully I can get out next year, about either in May or possibly out in the summer.
Okay, and then what do you want to do after you get the degree and you're out of there?
Well, I'm not sure exactly where I'm going to go, and I'm studying finance, but I don't know where exactly that's going to lead me. I hope I can maybe get into sales or something like that.
From the campus of El Dorado High School to the campus of the University of New Mexico, that's been the trek and a short one for Barry Garrison, the quarterback now at New Mexico. A hard 4 years of waiting in the wings for Garrison, but it paid off. He quarterbacks the Lobos now and still has the fond memories of being a great high school player at El Dorado High School. Our next broadcast, next Saturday night, tape delay when New Mexico takes on Brigham Young at University Stadium. Be sure to join Gary Ness and me then for exciting Lobo football. For Channel 14 Sports, this is Jim Lawwill reporting.
Back at Arizona Stadium, Jim Lawwill here along with Gary Ness. There's your halftime score. The University of Arizona 20, the New Mexico Lobos nothing. It's been an interesting first half, and when you take a look at the stats, you can see why. The Wildcats have totaled some yards, but the important thing, Gary, time of possession. The Lobos have not scored, but have had the football 18 minutes, 38 seconds to 11 minutes, 22 seconds for Arizona.
Well, it is. In fact, the most important statistic is that one that was on the screen first, the score, because if you look at the stats, you would never guess that score. And you look at the passing yardage, the Wildcats have 171 yards, slightly more than UNM, but 94 of them on a screen pass for a touchdown. Rushing, UNM is rather anemic compared to the Wildcats. Total yards, once again, the same, remove the 94 yards from the screen pass, and it's fairly even. Turnovers, UNM has an interception. Wildcats lost a fumble. Penalties fairly balanced out. First downs, look at that, Jim. 12 UNM, 8 Wildcats, but that all-important time of possession down there. You know what? There is a positive thing about that. That is that the defense has not been on the field very much, so maybe they won't get as tired in the second half. And if the Lobos can come out and establish something and score on their first possession, this may turn out to be a ball game yet.
Well, we did our stand-up to start the ball game. We talked about the fact if the Lobos can have the ball more than Arizona, they should be in the ball game. That was our feeling coming in.
Well, now they need three touchdowns, and here's the first score of the game. Coaston's field goal, he missed two last week. This one will just get over the crossbar to make it 3-0.
Doesn't get up very high.
Yeah, that's enough. Here it comes.
In the lower left-hand corner, just clears the crossbar, but it counts.
Now here's that quick kick by the Lobos. They were deep in their own territory, and they'll get a fumble on this and recover. John Duff, right place, right time.
Shane Hall is the one who booted it. There you see Chuck Cecil trying to make a grab. Chuck Cecil should have just backed off and let the ball roll. Instead, he blocked it like a shortstop, and John Duff got the ball, recovered it.
Now here, after the 46-yard punt return by Derek Hill, Waters is going to go to him again. Boy, this is just following the big punt return. The Wildcats have made the big play.
No pressure on Waters, and Derek Hill is awfully tough to cover one-on-one with his great speed.
10-0 here in Garrison, third and goal at the 6. Or rather, this is the play by Mathis that got them down to third and goal at the 6. Mathis can really get outside. Chuck Cecil, along with Todd Burden, to bring him down. And now here's the one that really hurt.
Here's the big play of the game. Now this is a screen pass caught right at the line of scrimmage by Greathouse. In fact, he almost dropped it there. I didn't see that originally. Now he gets outside of Martinez, gets outside the corner. Marcel Weiss overran him a little. But from here on, the only one with a chance is Darren Douglas, who will come into your picture from the top. However, with a blocker in front, that's Greathouse in front. Isn't it?
Well, I think it's Darrell Lewis.
Darrell Lewis in
Washington
front.
Carries it on in. He was running out of gas a little
screened
bit.
Screened him out.
And that hurt right there, because that made it 17-0. The Cats followed with the Mountain Cats, as they call them here, followed with a field goal at halftime. It's Arizona 20, the New Mexico Lobos nothing. We'll be right back with more, but first let's pause for this. Back at Arizona Stadium, 20-0, Arizona, as we get ready to start the second half of play. The Lobos won the toss but kicked off. Coach Mike Shepard does that. He likes to kick off. He wants the ball to start the second half. He hopes to do something positive. Although the Lobos trail 20-0, if you were with us at halftime, you noted time of possession went the Lobos' way. And with the exception of that big 94-yard touchdown pass, a school record for Arizona, really, the Lobos had outgained Arizona, had the ball longer. But the big play, the breakdown in special teams, and the costly interception on third and goal at the 6 of Arizona have kept the Lobos off the scoreboard. Gary, you're down 20-0. What must you do now? Obviously, you've got to move the football.
Well, you have to look ahead. What's past is past. You can't change that. You're starting out 20 points down, but this first possession is so key. You want to try to get some points on the board, maintain some ball control, get the ball downfield, and light up the scoreboard in some way. Psychologically, it would be a boost. Strategically, it would be a boost. It would put a little pressure on Arizona. Arizona knows. They know more than anyone that they haven't dominated the game. It hasn't been theirs. They haven't played their subs yet. I mean, it's been a matter of they've been opportunistic. So the Lobos need to get some points on the board, and I think things will settle down.
You caught that shot of the Lobo cheerleaders, the Lobo band here. Boy, those people work so hard, and sometimes people don't realize the hours of preparation they put in. Gary Coaston has kicked a 44-yard field goal and a 22-yard field goal. He'll kick it off. Mathis deep with Shane Hall. Terrence will get it at the goal line, and he will down it. Just inside the goal line, the Lobos start at their own 20, second half underway. Jim Lawwell here, along with Gary Ness. Our statistician tonight, Scott Rogers, and Mike Shamrell is our spotter. There is the rifle, the Kit Carson rifle, the winner of the game. Keeps the rifle, and the score is engraved on the butt end of the rifle.
Well, I think they had ran out of space on the butt, and they had to go
up
to the chamber there. The stock. Is that the right term, stock?
I hope so.
I do, too.
That's dangerous. All right. Well, Lobos, first and 10 at their own 20. There's the pass complete to Al Owens, and the Highland product, the former Trackster turned football player, has a first down. It's exactly what the Lobos needed. Chuck Cecil and James DeBow came in to sandwich the junior Al Owens.
Barry threw that with authority, and once again, there was no No rush from the Arizona defense, so those were positive signs.
You drive down and score a touchdown here, and you're right back in the football game. If you've watched it with us, you realize that Hobos have not been dominated like the score would indicate. Garrison throws to Hall, incomplete. The Wildcats read that play very well. They had pressure on the outside to chase Garrison out of the pocket, and then the pass was up high, and Hall just basically looks like he played like a defensive back, just kind of flipped it out of bounds.
Yeah, well, Beasley was out there, too. If they're going to throw that, they need to sprint out and keep that end rusher on the line of scrimmage on the line. They need to expend one of those backs to block him. Then he would have the time to throw and turn up and challenge the line of scrimmage.
Arizona will play UCLA at UCLA next week. The Lobos at home against BYU in their home opener. We'll have that one for you. Same day coverage, tape delayed. Here's Garrison on the roll, throws downfield, incomplete. Tony Jones was the intended receiver. Again, pressure coming from the George Hinkle, the senior left tackle, as he was chasing Garrison, who was harried as he tried to deliver the pass.
And that was the first time tonight, I can remember, Jim, where we have seen the shotgun formation. What he did was started from his position and sprinted for the sideline, trying to get outside that Hinkle, but Hinkle's denying him.
Lobos at just outside their own 33, third and 10. There's Garrison. Back to pass. Garrison with time. Throws. Bounced it in there to Al Owens. So it'll be fourth down, and the Lobos will have to punt the football. Interesting score in the third quarter. Texas Christian, TCU, beating BYU 21-3. That's a bit of a surprise.
That's a lot of a surprise. After beating Texas last week, I would have thought BYU wouldn't have had any trouble with TCU.
Steve Albrecht to punt it. A high spiraling punt. Derek Hill is dangerous. He takes it, and he is dropped. Thomas Crum, nice open field tackling. Jack Stanton, defensive coordinator, teaches that as well as a special teams coach. Get down, get them low, and drop them. We're going to pause, and we'll be right back.
47-yard punt.
Back in Tucson, here's Waters. First and 10, a running play with Darrell Lewis, the 5'9 freshman, slashing Lewis on a bit of a counter play. Got across the 25 in Wildcat territory to the 26-yard line. It'll be second down and 8. There's the Lobo bench. Gary, tell us what's going on there right now.
Art Valero is talking to his offensive line there, and he's talking about leakage in the protection, which we saw on second and third downs on the previous possession.
Out of the wishbone, Waters. Well, they try the middle, and they'll get about 4 up to the 30-yard line. Waters in the first half passed for 138 yards, rushed for 35. So the quarterback, after SMU got the death penalty, in fact, he called. Coach Toomey, as they call him here, or Toomey, we've heard both pronunciations over the years, but he called the coach and said, I'd like to come to Arizona, and he did, and he's their man this season.
I think Coach Toomey was happy to get him, don't you?
I would think so. He's a fine athlete. Third and a long 4. Waters to throw, in trouble. McCabe sacks him at the 20-yard line. Brian McCabe. Perhaps a little swim technique there. Coach, and he got by him, and he sacked the quarterback.
It looked like it. It was maybe a little water polo there. But finally some penetration as we watch number 52 break through the middle. There it is. Still had to spin him around once.
McCabe came all the way from New York to join the Lobo football program. They're trying to block the punt. They just missed it, and the punter for Arizona, Holly, got a good one off, and here's Randy Johnson. Managed to eschew one tackle, but then just got 2 or 3 later. Johnson has some nifty moves.
Yes, he does. That was Chuck Cecil, number 6, bearing down on him in the open field, and he niftily evaded him.
We're going to be right back. Lobos trail it. They've got the football. Stay with us now, won't you? At their own 37-yard line. Garrison 16 of 29, 157 yards. One costly interception. Looking deep for Mathis again. Mathis runs to it and had it and dropped it. Boy, it was a tough catch. He had to cut around the defender. But again, Terrence had his hands on it deep and couldn't manage to gather it in. Mathis just simply outruns any defender that tries to stay with him. James DeBoe was trying to handle
Terrence Mathis, and it is not an easy task.
Terrence runs so easily. He merely glides, and he doesn't look like he's straining to outrun anybody, and yet he passes the defenders.
Second and 10 for New Mexico. They trail 20 to nothing. They have good field position. 12:26 to go, third quarter. Garrison back again over the middle. That's Henderson, and he drops the football. Henderson, the freshman out of Huntington Beach, California. Again, Gary, a youngster, and apprehension more than anything causes that kind of a drop.
Well, sure. He looked up. He had to catch that over the middle. Anyone who catches the ball over the middle is aware of the presence of other defensive players. You saw all the motions that are and gestures that the coaches use on the sideline to signal the play into Barry Garrison, the quarterback.
The tandem of running backs, Reggie Rogers and Shane Hall. Garrison ready. Third and 10. Back to throw. Play action fake. Garrison with time over the middle, looking. Broken up and nearly picked off. Excellent coverage for Arizona that time. He can't play it any better than Darrell Jones did, the sophomore out of San Bernardino, California. Tipped it away, then nearly went and picked it off.
You couldn't convince Al Owens, number 82, that this wasn't interference. I don't see interference, but the camera angle that we have would not show it here.
The punt nearly blocked. Lobos just get it out. Should take a Lobo roll, and it does. And grabbed and hitting the deck with a football, Derek Hill. So Arizona again starts at their 22-yard line. And right now the two ball clubs are just exchanging punts. 12:10 to go, third quarter. Arizona leads it. The Wildcats 20. The Lobos nothing. Back in Tucson, Arizona. Jim Lawwell along with Gary Ness. Tom Basie of Arizona, they tell us, is out with a bad shoulder. He'll be out for the ballgame. Alonzo Washington carried the ball that time, in case you were wondering. There's the Lobo sideline. Mike Shepard, the new head coach, and he trails 20 to nothing. I know he's scratching his head a little bit.
Well, he...
Waters, second down, we'll call it 8. Option play. They get him, and Waters keeps his feet and gets 4 yards when he was dropped at the line of scrimmage, seemingly, I believe. Art Martinez had him, and then he got away. It'll be third and short for the Wildcats.
The people played their defensive responsibilities well there. You saw Art Martinez grab a foot, but Bobby Waters just had too much balance. He wasn't going to go down, and a little bit of determination besides.
So the Wildcats, third and 2 at their own 30. The wishbone employed, this time by Arizona. Waters takes it. He keeps it. Pitches. They get the first down. That's Elridge breaking tackles, but he stepped out of bounds. They're going to mark him down, I believe, inside the 35-yard line. It's enough for a first down.
Now, what Bobby Waters, number 2, did there was what an experienced wishbone quarterback could do. Short yardage situation. The Lobo defense strung it out. That means they forced him to pitch the ball, but he got it on the money for the short game and first down.
Out of the wishbone, Arizona. Inside their own 34. They'll run it with Elridge, and he's dropped at the line of scrimmage. Dave Elridge, the sophomore who started last week but was moved back to the second team this week. Waters, the quarterback for Arizona, and he is a good athlete, has rushed 9 times now and has 35 yards to his credit. Almost 4 yards a carry. That's not bad. There's Brian McCabe. Lobo defense. Second down, 10 yards for Arizona. Wide receivers to each side of the field out of the wishbone. Waters this time fakes, looks to throw, does. Boy, nice coverage, but Fairholm breaks the tackle and gets across to 40. It looked like Troy Clewis might have had a shot at picking that off and taking it in for a touchdown.
I really do. I agree with you, Jim. Let's see on the replay if he does. It looks like Troy Clewis actually runs around the football to make the tackle. You've got to play that ball. Let's see what happens.
Third and 3 for the Wildcats.
I guess we
won't
get the replay.
As a defensive back, they teach you to play the ball.
Well, and of course, it's tough to do that when you know the ball's coming and the receiver's got a shot at it.
Third and three, big down for the Lobo defense. Waters counters, heads up the field, dives, has a first down. He's across the Arizona 45, and it'll be first and 10 Wildcats. They've pieced together two first and 10s now. 9:24 to go, third quarter. Time is on the side of the Wildcats. They lead it 20 to nothing. It is imperative that the Lobos do not allow the Wildcats to score anymore. They need to get on the board.
Basically a wishbone for Arizona, because they look up and they see five defensive backs deployed by UNM, so they're going to stay on the ground, stay with a wishbone attack.
Hill to the top ear screen. That's McGill, the freshman, in motion. Here's the counter to Greathouse, and he gets away from one tackler. Boy, nearly having him in the backfield that time was Musa Kanicki. But he got by Musa. Lobos dropped him after a gain of a mere two, however.
Second and eight.
Player down for the Lobos.
Bobby Edwards, and the Lobos cannot afford to lose another defensive lineman, but Bobby Edwards is down in front of the Lobo bench.
Apparently holding the left knee. American Toyota is proud to be a sponsor of UNM Lobo football right here on KGSW TV 14. American Toyota, New Mexico's number one Toyota dealership.
Minnesota leads California 25-17 in the fourth.
Oh, I know Coach Michael White doesn't want to see a loss of another one of his defensive linemen. That's probably the thinnest group on the Lobo football team right now. And if Bobby has played well tonight, I know they'll be sorry to lose him if that's the extent of his injury.
Well, hopefully he'll be all right. Right now they'll help him off the field. Premiering this week, Gimme a Break and Family Ties. Also, Simon and Simon. All of that Monday, beginning at 7 p.m. on KGSW TV 14. Good job, you guys in the truck. Greathouse, 7 yards, 47 yards rushing. Here's a little fake by Waters. No, he did give it off that time. A lot of action, only a couple of yards that time for Arizona. Much like in the first quarter, content now to run the football.
Well, when they play five defensive backs, Ben Griffith is not going to throw against that. He's going, unless he does judiciously, if he tries to draw Lobos into a short yardage situation. But there's Orlando Lavelle, fresh face in there, and Mickey Armijo, 69, trying to get some more power in that defensive front.
You can see it there, third and five, a big play for the Lobo defense. Waters, a long count, rolling right. Looks downfield, scrambles. Boy, he's elusive. I believe the Lobos stopped him short, however, just outside the 45 in Lobo territory.
It's going to be close. If Clay Orris, a number 49, would have just gotten a hand on Waters, he did force Waters up inside, but he had Waters in the backfield.
Oh, my goodness, the wave starting again.
Apparently, having crossed midfield, the Wildcats are going to go for this fourth and one.
Waters would seemingly rather run than pass. Fourth and less than a yard. Waters out of the wishbone. They try the right side. Elridge dives, and he has it. First and 10, Arizona at the 42-yard line of New Mexico.
Gain of four on the carry by Elridge, going down by Art Martinez.
Art Martinez and a host of Lobo tacklers, and on the stop, there's Elridge. Started last week, but moved back, as we mentioned, to the second team this past week.
Elridge is a big back. He's 6'1", 235, and he shows it right there. That's who you want carrying it on that fourth and one situation.
First downs now. Arizona catching up. 14, Lobos. 10, Arizona. Arizona leads 20 to nothing, believe it or not. Dive play, fumble. Lobos have the football at the 40-yard line. The one thing about the wishbone is that it can produce turnovers. And the Lobos have the fumble recovery. Pulling it down for New Mexico. Picking up the football, David Ziegler.
There you see it. Now watch Ziegler, opportunistic linebacker from Highland High School, Coach Bill Gentry. Big play for Ziegler right there.
And the Lobos will have it when we come back. A touchdown, and, well, we're going to keep it right here, so stay right with us. I know you maybe started up to get your favorite beverage, but Lobos have it. Good field position. 20-0 the score. Touchdown here puts the Lobos in it. Pass complete. A short gainer. It looked like Beasley might have hit the receiver for New Mexico, Scott Howard, a little early, but Howard didn't let it bother him. He gathered in the football. And just as good as a running play. Got a little less than 4 yards.
This is some catch by Scott Howard. He very definitely was hit before the reception, and had he not hung on to it, I think we would have seen a flag.
Well, the penalty, however, would net a little more, wouldn't it, Gary?
Yes.
There's Garrison's numbers. He's had a good night. Here's a running play, Scott Howard. And Howard, the St. Pius product, across the 45 and over the 46-yard line. So many times in the past, you have seen players out of the state of New Mexico not be scholarship players, but walk on and then play a great deal for New Mexico. You see a number of New Mexico players on scholarship now playing for the Lobos, and young players.
Well, for example, Scott Howard, who just ran the ball, he's a scholarship player. Mickey Armijo's making the long snaps and playing some on the defensive line tonight. He was a walk-on who earned a spot on the team.
Third and three, New Mexico. Garrison to throw. Didn't have it, now throws incomplete. He had the receiver open. I believe he was trying to go to Tony Jones, but he threw the ball in behind him. And again, the Lobos will have to punt. And Gary, the one thing the Lobos need to do is get down and get some points on the board. 5:25 to go in the third quarter.
That's right. There was just a timing problem with that. He wanted to throw the ball right at the line of scrimmage, but a linebacker stepped in between, so then he retreated a couple more yards, and it was too late.
Albrecht aims for the corner with a punt. Cecil will take it at the 12, stutter steps, 15, heads backwards, and is dropped. Thomas Crum has really done a good job on the punting team this season for the Lobos with the good downfield tackling. Downfield tackling is an art. It's hard to do.
And Thomas has shown some skill at it tonight.
And we'll be right back, 5:16 to go third quarter. There is your score. Time and your score. New Mexico trailing it. Three times with the ball, three punts for New Mexico. Here's Ronald Veal, the young quarterback. And here's Elrich to run, far side of the field. Lobos close in and drop him, but he carries tacklers all the way to the 20-yard line. So after the punt pinned the Wildcats deep in their own territory at the 12, they net 8 yards on first down.
Eldridge, it's hard to believe that he wasn't starting tonight. He did start against Iowa the previous week. Now watch him run through some tackles there. Clay Orison in pursuit. Danny Lara comes up, seemingly has him. But Clay Orison and Art Martinez have to clean up.
Out of the wishbone, second and short. Here is Derek Hill, and when he gets outside, he'll show you something. A little jitterbug move. He's got the first down and much, much more out to the 32-yard line. Troy Clewis leading the way for the Lobos. But this is what Arizona wants to do. Grind out some clock. 4:35 to go third quarter.
Now this guy is dangerous when he gets in the open field. Look at those steps there. Out, ducks inside of both Troy Clewis and Danny Lara.
Gary, I know you've tried to tackle a guy that does that kind of thing. It's not easy.
No, and you can look foolish. You can end up on the ground with nothing.
First and 10, Arizona. That's Greathouse, and he doesn't get a great deal, however. Maybe a yard. Second and 9 will be the count for Arizona. Lobos need the football back. You drive down, you get a score here. 4 minutes to go third quarter. It's 20-7. He's still got 15 minutes to come back and win the football game. But the Arizona defense has been able to stymie the Lobos in the third quarter, much like the Lobos have been able to stop Arizona.
And the offense moved it out of a hole right there after the good kick coverage by Crum.
Now Veal is the youngster. He could be prone to a turnover. Here's a little running play with Hill, and he stumbled and then fumbled the ball. Lobos claiming they have it. Boy, look at that scramble. Lobos say we've got it, and if they do, this is the biggest break of the game for New Mexico.
It's certainly the best break. They're down in here closer. Danny Lara.
Danny Lara had the fumble. There he is. Congratulations.
He's returning to the lineup tonight after suffering a badly bruised ankle. You don't see many bruises to the joints, but he had a bruised ankle in Utah that kept him out of
the game last week at New Mexico State.
You cash in here, you're right back in the football game. 3:33 to go, third quarter. Garrison with two running backs this time, dropped straight back with all the time in the world over the middle. Dropped by Mathis. Had it, dropped it. Second and 10, New Mexico.
The Lobos attempted the play that they used on a successful third down conversion in the first half. Have Mathis streak across underneath the coverage, just behind the line of scrimmage. Drop it to him and let him get what he can.
The Lobos need to cash in here. Garrison at the throttle. Straight back again. Pump fakes, looking deep. Now goes into flat complete. Great execution at the 25-yard line, a gain of 8. Terrence Mathis looked that time, Gary, to me like he started deep and then came back for the football after the pump fake.
Well, Reggie Rogers out of the backfield is clearing the area, and then we didn't see on the replay, but he did give a pump fake, as you said. That freed Mathis underneath the coverage.
Third down, less than 2 for the Lobos. Inside the Arizona 25. Garrison, a key third down play. The senior quarterback to throw. Over the middle, complete to Shane Hall. Shane Hall is in the mold of a Fred Biletnikoff. If you watched him in practice, you'd say, well, he's not very big. He doesn't run very fast. He's not very strong.
But he makes clutch plays for you, as this one right here. Look at that. That pass isn't thrown very far, and he knows the linebacker's right with him, so that he's going to get hit immediately, but he's already crossed the line of scrimmage, got the yardage for the first down. All he has to do is catch it. I say all he has to do as if it were simple.
Garrison, 4-for-11 in the second half, but he's had a few dropped. Double wide receivers to the top of your screen. You can't see that right now. Line of scrimmage shot, and Garrison to throw, tipped away, and oh, nearly picked off. Todd Burden, who had an interception earlier, came out of nowhere, and was it Chuck Cecil coming in to break that play up?
Well, the play that was developing was the quick screen, but it was Cecil on a blitz who tips the ball up in the air. You see, the ball was to go to Mathis at the top of the screen, with Shane Hall and Al Owens, the other wide receivers, out there to block for him. But Cecil, on a blitz, got a piece of that ball. Had he not, that might have gone for good yardage, maybe a score.
Second and 10 at the Arizona 22, 2:20 to go, third quarter. Garrison to throw with time over the middle. Cat tips, picked up, incomplete. My goodness, ball was tipped, nearly picked off, then Mathis had it. He'd have been in for a touchdown.
Well, this will be fun to watch. First, it will be tipped. There you are. Cecil? No, Jones, number 5.
And then he nearly got it coming
then,
back.
That's right. Then it went to Terrence Mathis' hands and almost back to Jones.
Oh, yeah. What a sequence of events. Third and 10, New Mexico. Big play for Garrison. Hall's the lone running back. Pressure's on. They want to screen it to Hall, and he's buried. In fact, they lost about 5 yards on the play. Dana Wells, the junior nose guard, read it perfectly. Now, here comes Rick Walsh to kick the field goal.
Arizona had that one completely stymied. They were looking for the screen on this play. They had scouted this one well. When your nose guard makes the tackle in the flat, he's looking for the screen pass.
Lobos need this field goal, Gary. They get this, and they got something to tuck inside their cap. 43-yard attempt. He's going to kick it long enough, and it's good. He got it in there, so Walsh comes through. A minute and a half to go in the third quarter. The Lobos lead the third quarter 3-0, but it's 20-3 right now. This should be encouraging, Gary. They're finally on the board, and they've got 16 and a half minutes. You can do a lot, especially
right.
With a passing game.
That's right. They've played almost a quarter, and the Wildcats haven't done anything to pad their lead at all, and the Lobos are chipping away.
We had the one drive where Arizona got 3 first downs, and they fumbled it away. That's been it. All right, premiering this week, it'll be Gimme a Break and Family Ties. This Thursday night, two new shows coming to KGSW-TV 14. At 5, Neil Carter stars in Give Me a Break, and at 6, it's the premiere of Family Ties, who stars Michael J. Fox, who is a teen prop. That's more of your favorites on KGSW-TV 14. And, of course, Michael J. Fox is only 5'4" tall, so he has proven that you don't have to be huge to have a lot of success.
My daughter Rebecca doesn't know he's that tall or that short, however you want to look at it, but she thinks he's a doll.
Yeah. Here's an onside kick, and the Lobos needed to kick it 10 yards, and Albrecht kicked it right directly from the 35-yard line, and now Arizona is really in great field position.
Well, it was a gamble, but it didn't pay off. Let's see what happens here. I'm sure that Arizona will accept the ball here, or they could make him kick it from 5 yards deeper from the 30, but it will be accepted. This puts a little bit of pressure on the defense.
Albrecht's onside kick needs to go 10 yards. 1:26 to go, third quarter, 20-3, Arizona leading it. Wildcats with a gift. And now the Lobos hoping to unravel it. There's the young quarterback in there again, Ronald Veal. In motion, Darrell Lewis, another freshman. Veal ready to his left. Throws, incomplete. Boy, Art Martinez read that very well, and what a stinging hit on Darrell Lewis, the freshman. He'll think twice about that reception attempt next time.
Yes, Darrell Lewis may wake up tomorrow morning and look at that 35 on a white shirt. He may see that in his dreams. Arizona has fumbled on their last two possessions, and it was hits like that which have been forcing fumbles. So if the defense can rise to the occasion once again, create another turnover.
Second and 10, Arizona, at the 37-yard line of New Mexico. Lewis is in motion, coming to the bottom of your screen. Veal, a little draw, and Alonzo Washington, who went 94 yards on a pass play earlier, is dropped after a mere gain of a yard. Lobos reading that one well. Musa Kanicki, along with Kirk Allen, combining on the tackle for the Lobos.
Lobos seem to be containing the wishbone better, and then here we have a third and 9 situation. This is a big down. They may not be in Coston's field goal range yet.
Well, to your left and to the bottom of the screen, Derek Hill, the speedster, has checked in. Greathouse is in motion. Looks like they're going to pass it. And Veal is back. Downfield, incomplete. Boy, Hill broke into the area around the 17 and hooked in. He was open, but he couldn't hang on to the football.
I think he sneaked a peek at Kirk Allen, number 38, crossing the field. Had he caught that, he would have had to contend with Kirk Allen. But the Lobo defense does the job right here.
This will be a field goal attempt of 53 yards by Coston. Now, he has the leg. Remember, he missed 2 last week, but in the season opener last year, and Arizona would go 9-3, go to the Aloha Bowl and beat North Carolina. After an opening game where he didn't kick well, he was on fire the rest of the season. He has booted a 44-yarder tonight and a 22-yard field goal. This one will be a 53-yarder. There really basically is not much of a breeze right now at all, and we're down to 41 seconds to go in the third quarter, Arizona leading at 20-3.
Now, as we see, Arizona has made a wholesale team change. Are they still? No, they are going to the punt now. So evidently they changed their mind, thus the timeout. They got their punting team on the field.
Brett Hawley is the punter. Well, that means Arizona has lost a very valuable timeout. And in case you were wondering, the Lobos have all of theirs left. And last week, the statisticians in the media area for radio and TV told us at the end of the ballgame that New Mexico had 2 timeouts. We found out after the game. Of course, the clock was out and it was difficult. It was a very confused situation. But Gary and I found out after the game, the Lobos were out of timeouts. But we have to go with the information we're given. And, of course, we want everyone to understand that because a lot of people wondered why the Lobos didn't use them. It's because, in reality, they did not have them. But they've got 3 left here. A long count. They're trying to draw the Lobos offsides, perhaps. Hawley waiting and waiting on the snap. If they can back up 5 yards, it'll be an easier punt for him, and that's what they'll do. The delay of game on Arizona cost them 5 yards. 20-3, the Lobos trail.
I'll tell you what, this has been an outstanding defensive stand here to turn the ball over on their own 35, 37-yard line in this situation and stop Arizona flat with nothing, force them to punt here. I can't give enough credit to Stanton and his defensive crew.
Lobo defense has given up 20 points, 17, and 20 tonight to three high-powered offenses. In fact, Utah has scored over 30 on their next two opponents. Here's the end-over-end kick towards the corner. Randy Johnson over. We'll have to let it roll, and the Wildcats down it at the 13 of New Mexico. So he can't do it any better than Brett Hawley did. He got it off the instep and dropped it in the corner.
Kevin Singleton down the wall.
Not what you'd call ideal field position for the Lobo offense, but
at the 13,
they have the only score of this half, and they've got a quarter and 33 seconds to go to get back in this game.
10 for the Lobos at their own 13.
Lobo football on KGSW-TV is brought to you in part by Coors Light. There's no slowing down with the silver bullet. Garrison at the Lobo 13. A running play this time, and not much there for New Mexico. The attendance tonight, 46,094, so we thought about 48. We were a bit shy, but it's a very good crowd here at Arizona Stadium. That was the attendance last week. In fact, it was a little over that. It was a record 57,000, around 800 and some standing room. And this week, they dropped down to a mere 46,000 plus.
Second and 11 at the 12.
Here's Garrison to pass, second down in his own territory. Dumps it off incomplete to Tony Jones. Jones paid the price after he didn't make the catch.
If Terrence Mathis on the near sideline was running an optional route, that means if he could break it off in front of the defender or run past the defender, in that situation, he should have broken it off in front. And I think Barry wanted him to do that.
Into the third quarter, 20-3 is your score. We're going to be right back with the fourth and final period in just a moment. Back at Arizona Stadium as we get ready to start the fourth quarter, Jim Lowell along with Gary Ness. And Gary, 20-3, but it's been much closer than that for the Lobos, but they'll have to get the offense moving in the final stanza.
They're going to have to score on this possession to get back in the game, put some pressure on the Wildcat defense.
All right, let's get back to the action, and we're glad to have you with us tonight here at Arizona Stadium. 20-3, the Lobos trail it. The Lobos have the football starting the fourth period, and they'll move from right to left on your TV screen. It's third and a little more than 10 outside their own 12-yard line. Third down conversions, 50% for the Lobos, 7 out of 14. Garrison to throw. He has time, looking downfield. Throws, incomplete, and then nearly caught as it went off the hands of John Duff, and Terrence Mathis nearly managed to lasso it, but the Lobos now will have to punt from deep in their own territory, and again, the Lobo defense will be put to a test.
It appears as though... Well, I'm not sure he was throwing for Mathis. I think he was throwing for John Duff, but...
Both of them had it in their hands. Couldn't hang on. Here's the kick by Albrecht, a short one. Here's Derek Hill, and he's dropped. That's Thomas Crum with his third great open field tackle. There's a real art to that.
An art and a lot of courage and fortitude. Thomas Crum has done, that's the second really fine punt cover they've had tonight by Thomas Crum.
37-yard punt for Albrecht. His kicks have not been much more than of the 40-yard variety this evening.
In that situation, punting out of your own end zone, that puts a lot of pressure on Mickey Armijo from Santa Fe High, who was making the deep snap. But it was true, and Albrecht got it off.
Arizona with great field position at the Lobo 49-yard line, leading 20-3, just underway fourth quarter. Long count. Here's Ronald Veal, heading left with room. Across the 40, penalty marker dropped. Might had a clip downfield by the Wildcats that time, and that'll move them back considerably.
Or the lead back making a block may have reached out with a hand and tackled the support from the secondary on the defense. Yes, that's what it is.
All righty. Very astute, Gary. course, you know what those running backs, those tricks that they'll utilize to try to get that block.
Yeah, when you see a play, you know what stops it. And when you see a flag on that play, it pretty well, you know what stops it.
Five penalties now, 43 yards for Arizona.
20.
Well, they've got first and 20, and I guess that's what it is. It is first and 20. That moves the Wildcats back into their own territory. That's the run and shoot right there. Ronald Veal back to throw, moves to his right. Throws downfield, incomplete. David Elridge was the intended receiver. Quite frankly, Wildcats passing game tonight, they've got a lot of yards because of the 94-yard touchdown pass, which was a screen that broke from deep in Wildcat territory, and the 25-yard pass for the touchdown. With the exception of that, the Wildcat passing attack really has not been that fruitful.
Well, and in that situation, see, the Lobos are playing with what they call their nickel package, which means five defensive backs. They've sacrificed a linebacker for a defensive back. They don't want him to throw. But in that situation, Veal had a first down and more had he elected to run, but he threw the ball downfield, thus the incompletion.
Second and 20, Arizona, at their own 41. Veal backs up, looking deep, fires, nearly picked off. Art Martinez been all over the field tonight.
I was going to say, we need a nice word like omnipresent to describe Art Martinez, or ubiquitous, something like that, because you saw him earlier making tackles up on the line of scrimmage, behind the line of scrimmage, and there he is, 20 yards deep, knocking down that pass play, almost intercepting it.
Veal's passing, 2 for 7, 54 yards.
Of course, we might follow up by saying, Jim, that he's playing in front of his home crowd. Art is from this area, from Sal Point High School.
Great house in motion. Third and 20. The freshman quarterback to Alonzo Washington. Breaks a tackle. There he goes. First and 10. And out of bounds at the Lobo 37. Boy, you scratch your head and wonder, how did he get that far on third and 20?
How did he elude Kirk Allen's tackle? Now, this screen is set up very well. We saw Billy Rucker and throw this pass many times for New Mexico, but now there goes Kirk Allen, but across the face of the ball carrier, and Alonzo gets the first down.
22 yards on the pass play to Alonzo Washington, and now Arizona first and 10 inside the 37 of New Mexico, 14:05 to go in the game. Plenty of time. Arizona leading New Mexico 20-3. Flags are down as Washington tries the right side and heads up field to the 32 of New Mexico. Looked like some mass confusion in the middle of the offensive line from our vantage point.
Well, they were going to try a counter option play.
This is Lobo Football on KGSW TV 14, the great entertainer, Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Kirk Allen deciding to accept the penalty.
First and 15 now for Arizona.
Excuse me, on that illegal shift, only one of the backs can move at one time or can be in motion, and both wingbacks thought they were to be in motion that play.
Alonzo Washington has caught only two passes for Arizona, but for 116 yards, and both of them he caught just around the line of scrimmage.
And both of them screen passes, that's right.
Now first and 15 for the Wildcats. Elridge is in motion. Here's the young quarterback rolling to his right. Throw downfield. Oh, picked off and dropped. Boy, Derek Hill came up and laid the leather on Kirk Allen. It looked like Chris Houston. It looked like Houston had the interception.
Chris Houston played that perfectly. He got in position. He dropped off the receiver in the flat, backed up to get in line for that pass, and it was right in the numbers.
So the freshman, Ronald Veal, forced it that time. Veal brings up the Wildcats. They've got Derek Hill to the bottom of the screen along with McGill. Two guys that can really motor. That's Elridge in motion. Here's Veal to throw. Now he'll scramble, hits his own man, heads outside, comes up, breaks away, 35, dives to the 32-yard line. Veal is an exciting open field ball carrier.
Well, you see why the Wildcat coaching staff is so high on this freshman. Watch his feet. Now, how does he get out of some of these? Look, his own man bumps into him, tight end. Now, he has a blocker in front, but he's contained. Chris Houston reaches out, almost snatches the ball from him before he's finally tripped up.
Musa Kanicki is the Lobo player who's down, and they just simply cannot afford any more injuries in the defensive front. We're going to take time out, 13-11 to go in the fourth and final quarter, Arizona 20, New Mexico 3. Here's Veal, the quarterback. The late pitch to Alonzo Washington, and Washington will be just a bit shy of a first and 10. It'll be close. Arizona running some clock right now, 12:40 and counting remaining. They lead the Lobos 20-3. They're going to call timeout and bring the chains across the field to come up with a measurement. There is Alonzo Washington. Caught a 94-yard touchdown pass. Bobby Waters, the senior quarterback for Arizona, is out with a bruised right hip, but he may return if they need him. They play UCLA next week, however, at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, they probably want to keep him healthy for that encounter. It's a Pac-10 game.
And the bad news for the Lobos, we had heard too, is that Bobby Edwards, their defensive lineman, has a badly sprained ankle, and no telling when he will be back, but certainly not tonight.
Arizona, third downs, 4 out of 11. They simply have not been that effective. Of course, you say, well, they've been effective enough. They're leading 20-3. As you saw on the measurement, they're shy.
Just barely. This is the place for a quarterback sneak. But let's see if Beal does that. Well, I can tell you right now, if there's no linebacker who steps up in the middle, they will.
Yeah, fourth and inches. They try the running play. Elridge dives, and it's going to be very close. They got a pretty good mark.
Art Martinez, number 34, made the stop.
He didn't make it by much, if he did.
It's going to be very close. They'll bring the chains across the field again. Touchdown passes of 25 and 94 yards for Arizona, coupled with two field goals of 44 and 22 yards, and then a 44-yard field goal by Rick Walsh of New Mexico. Boy, it is going to be close. I don't think they got it. Hector, they don't have it.
They're further away than when they started. Great defensive stand there.
The Lobo defense over the past three games, quite frankly, has not been that bad, and they have had a lot of injuries to deal with. A quick touchdown here, 12:29 to go. It's 20-10, and you've got an opportunity to perhaps win the football game or at least kick a field goal, score, and tie it, maybe go for two. There's a lot of options, but they need to strike quickly now, do the Lobos. Garrison. His lone running back is Shane Hall. Two wide receivers to the top of your screen. Here's Garrison downfield, complete to John Duff. Oops, he dropped it. Well, that would have been a big gainer. Duff was there. He simply could not catch the football.
Well, you see why Chuck Cecil is their All-American safety, too. Chuck Cecil is not very big. They list him at 175 pounds. But he really hits Duff hard. And Duff had to turn around for the ball, so he took it in the back. Couldn't hang on. You know, you made the observation, score quickly, and that's what has to be done. In fact, there is some confusion right here. Barry wants to discuss this on the sideline. So does Scott Maney.
So the Lobos will use a timeout with 12:21 to go in the football game. Arizona leading New Mexico 20-3. Stay with us now, won't you? We'll be right back.
back at Arizona Stadium. Jim Lawwill here along with Gary Ness. Second down, 10 for New Mexico at their own 27-yard line. They trail it 20-3. Garrison to throw with time. Throws. Caught. Al Owens, first and 10, spins and dives across the 40 to the 42-yard line. Excellent concentration by Al Owens that time.
Al Owens from Highland High School played for Coach Bill Gentry. And this is a classic catch, fingertip catch. We won't see a replay of it, but you heard the crowd woo as he caught that ball because he caught it in traffic, fully extended on the fingertips.
Lobos need to drive it down and score. They came into this football game 23-point underdogs. Owens has caught three passes now for 37 yards. Here's Hall going left. Not much there as they close in and drop him at the line of scrimmage. The ball came loose, but Shane Hall was down. Right there, Gary, it's the old string the play out. If you can string a play out, your pursuit will catch up with the play.
Well, Lobos do not have a running back with speed to turn the corner unless the corner is sealed. And the pursuit of the Wildcat defense is just too good. I mean, the Lobos are not going to run outside of it. They can throw in the flats, but they are not going to be able to run from the backfield and turn the corner against the Arizona defense.
Second and 10, New Mexico at the Lobo 41. Garrison to throw. Quickly to Mathis, got him. Mathis gets by one man and gets first down yardage into Wildcat territory at the 47-yard line. I get the impression that perhaps the Lobos could do that quite frequently.
This look-in pattern?
Yes.
Yes, it is against single coverage, and that's what he had that. But once they get double coverage and put a linebacker out there, you can't do that.
Exactly.
In fact, what Barry Garrison may have checked off with the line of scrimmage and call for that, having looked out there and seeing single coverage on Mathis.
Anytime they see that, Mathis, of course, usually will be open. First and 10 Lobos in Wildcat territory. Garrison with lots of time fires. There's Mathis. He breaks free. 30, 25. There goes Terrence. 10, 5. Touchdown, New Mexico. They needed that. And the Lobos are right back in the football game. A touchdown pass of 47 yards from Garrison to Mathis.
Indeed they are. That ball was on the money. Now look at that block by Shane Hall, number 9, on the defensive end. Now Cecil, the All-American, missed Mathis right there. And Terrence just simply runs away from other people. And look how effortlessly he runs.
In fact, Randy Kindred and Darrell Jones both had a shot at him, but he's just too fast. Here's the all-important extra point. 20-9 and a lot of time to go, 10:37 remaining. The Lobos are going to go for two here. Garrison to throw with time. Backpedaling, fires it in the end zone. Chuck Cecil breaks it up. Mathis was the intended receiver. Gary, why do you go for two there?
Well, let's see. That would have given him 11. They would have been 9. Just to get an extra point.
And we'll be right back. Terrence Mathis has caught 8 passes for 129 yards, an average of 16.1 yards. He leads the country in all-purpose yardage. He's an All-American candidate. He can do it all. And you Lobo fans can see him next Saturday evening at University Stadium against BYU.
And there's a good chance he still will lead the country in all-purpose yardage next week.
Well, Bobby Humphrey didn't have that good a day for Alabama, and he was second behind him. The Lobos have scored the touchdown. The two-point conversion didn't gel. A lot of time to go. 29 Arizona. Lobos very much in this football game. Derek Hill returns the kick. At the 20, the 25, into the 27-yard line. Guess who made the tackle? Thomas Crum.
He has been all over the field. Here's the attempt on the two-point conversion. Now, what they wanted to do was cross the field once again with Mathis, but Cecil was right with him all the way and broke up the play.
That's why Cecil is considered an All-American candidate. So Arizona leading 20-9. Here's the quarterback Veal on the pitch to McGill, another freshman, and he gets maybe a yard. That'll be it. Lobos read it well. Another Lobo leaving the field shaken up.
Clay Orison leaving the field.
Brian McKay back in there along with Musa Konecki, who we lost for one series.
Troy Clewis, number four, came up there and played. He was right on the pitch man on that option. The Lobos played that very well.
There's a Lobo drive. Seven plays. 73 yards. 149. They need to score quickly. And again, penalty markers dropped. I think the freshman quarterback, Ronald Veal, his cadence must be much different than that of the senior Bobby Waters, who left with a bruised hip, because the interior line for the Wildcats is struggling right now.
Well, that's right. And a freshman quarterback. We can almost hear him all the way up here, can't we? But the point about a freshman quarterback, another thing freshman quarterbacks don't do is if they don't see things on the defense and they don't have the experience to check off to a different play if the defense that they see is prepared to stop what was called in the huddle.
With 9:44 and counting remaining, if the Lobos stop them right here and get the football and score, they have a great opportunity to win this football game. Ronald Veal, the quarterback, and again penalty markers. And again the Wildcats move back five more yards. Veal might be shaking a little. Gary, it's become a close football game.
Well, very clearly that Tom Lynch, the left tackle, lifted his hand. Once you put your hand down, once those interior linemen put their hand down, whether it's one or if they use both hands, they can't move them until the ball is snapped, and that's what Lynch did. But more importantly, Jim, your point, not only Veal, but listen, there's pressure on Arizona, period. There's pressure felt on their sideline. Look, they haven't scored this half. The Lobos have scored nine, and they've taken momentum.
Here's Veal, second and 20. Hill in motion to the top of the screen. Veal rolls to throw. Likes to scramble and wheel. Lobos after him. He's at the 20, the 25, and breaks a tackle. Boy, he nets about 9 yards on that play. At least eight. It'll be third down and 12 for Arizona, but the Lobos in a contained defense, and they did what they wanted to do. They didn't let him get away for the big play.
Really puts pressure on linebackers like 38 Kirk Allen, who comes up. Once he gets into the flat here, an open field tackle on Veal is tough. Now, he has a blocker in front, wide receiver coming back, who knocked Kirk Allen out of the play.
Third down, and they call it 13. Big play for the Lobo defense. Veal, little counter run, heads up the field, and he will not get the first down. Well, check that. He will get the first down, rather. It was third down and three rather than third down and 13. Mathis now in his career has netted 2,236 yards, 18 touchdowns. That ties Mathis for 18th place on the all-time WAC receiving list. If he stays healthy, it looks like Terrence could become the all-time receiver in the history of the Western Athletic Conference. And up there nationally, really have an opportunity to be among the top 10. First and 10, Arizona. A running play with Greathouse, and he breaks out. And he'll go into Lobo territory. Inside the 45-yard line. Well, this is what the Wildcats needed to do, move the football and run some clock.
Well, this is becoming reminiscent, this inside running game against the Lobo defense in the fourth quarter. Here Danny Lara is trying to straighten him up. Runs by him. Brett Heber and Troy Clewis eventually have to corral him. Now there's a Lobo player down in the middle of the field.
Greathouse, the sophomore from Tempe, Arizona, has now rushed nine times for 54 yards in the football game. Toe Diem, who will be enshrined in the Alumni Association Hall of Honor, the Lobo trainer, checking on the injured Lobo player. Looks like Troy Clewis is the Lobo player down.
It's Troy Clewis who is trying to corral Greathouse on that play.
Well, we want you to stay with us tonight here on KGSW TV 14. Tonight at 11, Frank Sinatra, a tough guy, private eye. Tony Rome's the name. Jill St. John and Simon Oakland will also team with Sinatra as they star in tonight's feature on KGSW TV 14 Saturday night late movie. It's Tony Rome. First and 10, Arizona.
Lobos trail it 20-9, 8:21 to go. Here's the keeper by Beal. Beal is very elusive, and again, he'll get a big gainer on first down. Looks like he got 9 yards before the Lobos finally could get a hold of the freshman and throw him to the turf.
Cannot let a triple option quarterback keep the ball off tackle. Now Ziegler straightens up the dive man, but Kirk Allen runs by the quarterback.
Second and about a yard.
Lara tries to turn him in. You play that defensively. 1, 2, 3. You tackle him in order. Dive man, quarterback, and the pitch.
Art Martinez coming back to Tucson, his hometown, and he has really played an excellent football game. Second and short for Arizona. Action and movement in that offensive line again for the Wildcats. A big play after the two penalties of 5 yards with movement in the line. It was Veal who picked up that big gain of 17 yards. And then, of course, the ensuing first and 10, it was a big play on this drive. We have ticked down now to 7:32. 20-9, Arizona leads it. Lobos need to get the football back. A touchdown, of course, and then anything can happen.
Of course, unfortunately, on the negative side, they've lost their field position now. What they really need to do is to strip the ball somehow and create a turnover and not allow them to punch you back into your own end zone. We're looking out of the Lobos end zone right now.
We're going to break, and we're going to be right back. 7.5 minutes to go. Be a very good team. He's a Dick Toomey, or Tomey, however you want to pronounce it. He's the head football coach at Arizona now. You can see him on the sideline, down on the knee, headset on, leading 20-9. Second and 6 in Lobo territory, outside the 40, and the Lobos jump off sides, I believe. They could have been drawn off.
Well, here's that situation. Yes, a Lobo had penetrated the line of scrimmage, and the center saw this and then snapped the ball. We'll see what happens here. Even before the snap count was made.
Well, they were going to give it to the Lobos, but
so now we're back to the second and one.
And time, 7:32 to go, is ticking away on the University of New Mexico.
Second and less than a yard is the 35.
Veal, the quarterback, keeps it. Pitches outside. Lobos read it perfectly. Derek Hill is dropped for a big loss. Darren Douglas with a fine tackle. A loss, and it'll be third down now and about 3, and the biggest third down of the game for the Lobo defense. They must stop Arizona here.
The Lobo defense was prepared for that. They saw Hill come back in motion behind the backfield, and they knew he would become the pitch man, and Darren Douglas wasted no time in getting up and making that tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
Third down and 3 for Arizona. Outside the Lobo 37. Darrell Lewis in motion. Here's the young quarterback, Veal, hit and dropped. And they won't get it. It'll be fourth down. A field goal attempt would be about 56 yards. It looks like the punting team and Brett Holly are on the way. 6:25 and counting remaining. The Lobos get the football back. They'll have to strike quickly.
And what a remarkable play by Brian McCabe, who had been blocked off his feet and from his knees made that stop.
Holly to punt, Johnson is deep.
Got to be aware of a fake here, too. Johnson deep for the Lobos. Here's the punt. Boy, he hangs it up beautifully. Looks like it might carry into the end zone, and it does, fortunately. Boy, the Wildcats were in the end zone trying to get it. One of the officials is being booed because he was in the way, but I believe the Wildcats had already touched it in the end zone before that.
Yeah,
those poor guys in the striped shirts, they always get it from the fans. But he did. The field judge was wiped out on that play.
Of all the crews I believe we've seen, Gary, I think this is the best officiating crew we've seen this season.
I believe that was Bill Gaskins, the field judge, or at least he was in that position. Well, the Lobos have to score, and they have almost 6 minutes left to make up a difference of 11 points.
You're feeling on the officials. Would you agree with me?
Yes, yes. I have no complaints about the officials tonight.
Garrison needs to go 80 yards. You can't get it all in one chunk. He's back to pass, a four-man rush. With time, he now scrambles to his right.
throws up field, complete to John Duff, and then the ball comes free. I believe I've said that three times tonight regarding Duff. It looks like he has it, and then the ball just pops out.
And as Barry challenged the line of scrimmage, the man, Chuck Cecil, up on the sideline, had dropped off of Tony Jones, and Tony Jones is running free on the sideline. If Barry had seen him.
It appeared that Duff was gathering it in, and as he collided with the ground, the ball came loose. Second and 10, New Mexico, 5:49 to go. They trail it 20-9. They need a score. They need it quickly. Garrison back to throw with time, looking deep for Mathis. No for Owens. Well, incomplete. That time, they sent Owens down the sideline.
As you began to describe that play, you said, and they needed it quickly, and I think they heard you because they were going for all of it right there.
Hoping that Arizona would be conscious of Mathis, they decided to go with Al Owens, who is a trackster himself and runs well. On the coverage that time for Arizona, James Dubois, the junior strong safety. Third and 10, New Mexico. Out of the shotgun this time, and the Lobos need at least 10. They trail it 20-9. Garrison with time. Over the middle, complete to Mathis. Breaks a tackle and is dropped by Chuck Cecil. It appeared Mathis is such an exciting player that if Cecil doesn't piggyback him, he might be gone for a touchdown.
You get used to seeing, well, as you see him elude one tackler, he's gone, and he would have been. That was a tough catch because the ball was low. Watch him reach down for this and keep his balance. A little bit behind him. In fact, I think he used his knees to help him gather that in. Clutch play.
You look back at that interception on third and six at the Arizona 6 in the first half, and it looms kind of largely right now.
Sure does. Lobo cheerleaders have something to cheer about, especially if the Lobos score on this drive.
First and 10, Lobo 36. Here's Mathis. They're going to... Oh, a double pass downfield. Mathis throws incomplete. Al Owens, the intended receiver. You recall last year, before Mathis, well, many times in practice, Mathis would play not only wide receiver, but running back and quarterback, and there was talk that he might be quarterbacking the Lobos on a steady basis.
And it appeared as though the Arizona defense was looking for that. I'm sure that Ben Griffith wasted no time in sharing that information, that Mathis had worked as a quarterback when Ben coached him here at New Mexico.
Hey, you got to compliment the Wildcat secondary. They stayed home on that play.
And they sure did.
Second and 10, New Mexico. They trail it 20-9, 5:08 to go in the ball game. Mathis back to throw, dumps it off. Shane Hall with a block or two. He won't get much, maybe 2-3 yards. It'll bring up third and long for New Mexico. Wildcats closed in quickly on them. Mathis has caught 9 passes tonight, now for 145 yards. There's the time, there's the score. Lobos have won the second half, 9-0.
And if you want to know what the Lobos' clutch play would be on third and seven, there's no more critical third and seven than right now.
Mathis will go to the bottom of the screen, Owens to the top. There's Garrison, the senior quarterback, ranked second in the Western Athletic Conference coming into tonight's action. He wants to throw and he will. Downfield, Mathis, did he have it? Got away from it. He was open for the first and 10. He had to dive forward. Now it's fourth down, and maybe here you got to go for it.
Well, it's time escaping. Yeah, if you're going to, I think they are. There's no question about it. You can't count on more than 2 possessions left with 4:20 on the clock. So they're going to go for it. And here again, you want your 7-yard completion right here. You curl in pattern. Mathis was double covered that time, but he drove as he came off the line of scrimmage. He drove the defenders deep enough for Barry to throw it to him, but it didn't get there.
Garrison to throw, third and 7. Downfield has a man. Al Owens, first and 10 inside Wildcat territory at the 47-yard line of Arizona. Back on the coverage and making the tackle, Darrell Jones. If he doesn't, Owens could be gone, and Al Owens is down, and the clock will stop with 4:14 to go.
Another clutch catch. Look at him reach out. That's the second reaching out fingertip catch that Owens has made tonight. I think he's just had the wind knocked out of him. A lot of times a receiver, Jim, will catch the ball, and when they're tackled, they'll roll on the ball, and the ball under their stomach knocks the wind out of them. I think that's probably what happened.
You get in there, get a touchdown, go for two. You got an onside kick. You've got timeouts left, two of them. Time is on the side of Arizona. They lead it 20-9. Garrison brings up the Lobos. Back to throw with time. Garrison fires downfield. Complete to Duff at the 32-yard line. Another first and 10. Ball got free, but Duff was down.
Ball was right in there, thrown perfectly. He got hit. Duff is also, as a target, represents a big target for the passer, but he also represents a big target for the tackler. Now watch, he'll get hit low, right on the hip. You know, that was close to being a fumble. And as we look at it on the replay, the officials don't have benefit of that in college ball, but
there are the Arizona cheerleaders. They haven't had much to cheer about in the second half. They lead 20-9, though. Lobos at the 32 of Arizona, trying to get the touchdown. Garrison, 279 yards passing, as you can see on the graphic. Garrison throws. Dropped. Mathis had it, was trying to get out of bounds. He wanted to stop the clock, but Gary, you mentioned earlier, catch it first.
Yes, well, everybody drops him, even Terrence. As good as he is, everybody drops him sooner or later, but I'm sure he would have wanted to hang on to that one. Is Thomas Crum. Thomas Crum, number one in your picture there, is used to spell Mathis so that Mathis can get a breather and a play or two. But Thomas is a capable receiver.
Second and 10 for the Lobos at the Arizona 32.
3:23 remaining. Garrison with two running backs. They both fan out. He throws complete to Thomas Crum, who is wrapped up, tied up at the 27-yard line. Lobos might consider going without a huddle at this juncture.
Good for 5 yards. It'll be
they trail 20-9.
I think Thomas Crum isn't tough. First of all, he's a special teams player. Look at him bury that shoulder in there, and there's an Arizona player down.
Crum is a senior, 5'11". They list him at 191, but I don't believe he really weighs that much.
And he came to the program as a walk-on from Detroit and has made it. He's a kind of an inspirational guy, too. He always keeps the spirits up and keeps everybody in it.
There's part of the crowd of 46,000 plus.
They have some very high vertical decks here so that the fans feel like they're virtually looking down on top of the field.
3:01 to go for New Mexico. Time on the side of Arizona. The Lobos trying to punch in a quick touchdown. Six would give them 15. Then a two-point conversion could give them 17 if you can get it. Then a field goal can give you a tie. Garrison brings up the Lobos. Garrison back to throw over the middle to Mathis, complete, and he's all the way inside the 15 to the 14-yard line of Arizona.
There again was perhaps the automatic call. He may have changed that call at the line of scrimmage. That's that look-in pattern we were talking about earlier against single coverage. The only way to stop that play is to get somebody underneath or between Mathis and the ball, and you'd have to drop a linebacker off to do that because Mathis will turn that in front of the cornerback.
Gary and I joking last week about the two-minute warning because in college football you don't enjoy that luxury. 2:20 to go. Garrison to throw over the middle, complete to Duff. He doesn't get much. A gain of about three and a half to the 10-yard line. It'll be second down there. Jerry Beasley leading the way for the University of Arizona. 20-9, Arizona leading it. Lobos trying to punch it in, get the touchdown. Then do whatever they can do to try to get the ball back. They have two timeouts left.
At the end of three quarters, ASU 28, Pacific 3.
Garrison brings up New Mexico. He's going to throw. Looks inside, fires. Picked off by Chuck Cecil, and that'll be the ball game. Looking for Terrence Mathis over the middle, and Cecil read it all the way.
Somebody misread it. He threw an out pattern. But the route was an in pattern. And let's see, here's the... Chuck Cecil had the benefit of coming towards the ball. He could see it. And he was in the right place at the right time. That's what makes him an All-American.
Well, they talk about that, Gary. The great player makes the great play. Their backs were to the wall. Lobos looked like they had a shot. But the interception, now 1:43 to go. Now you must use your timeouts. Try to hope for a turnover, some kind of a big break.
And this is where you stunt on defense. You run people through gaps. You try to tackle the football. You get a little bit, you go for the big one here. I would not expect Arizona to put this ball in the air. What you defensively have to do here is make sure that you contain Veal, number 10, there in your screen. He is so elusive. Make sure that he has to cut inside his own tackles into the rest of the defense. Don't permit him to run outside.
Interestingly enough, timeout called by Arizona. Now the Lobos are home for the first time next week, a 6:05 start. And we'll have same-day coverage after the ballgame. Tape delay at 10. The Lobos and BYU. We certainly hope you'll join Gary and me then for that ballgame. BYU losing to TCU tonight in the battle of initials.
Battle of initials.
They could be 1-2 coming into the game. Encouraging second half for the Lobos. They really outplayed Arizona in both halves, but the big plays in the first half will haunt the Lobos as they board the charter and head back home.
The Lobos have to learn to be opportunistic, take advantage of what they have. They're doing the hard work, but it's the gravy that they need to be able to accept.
The Lobo drive stymied after 66 yards on 11 plays. It took them 4 minutes and 15 seconds, and then the interception, and they got nothing. Here's Veal, the freshman in the end zone, dumps it off to Greathouse, who breaks it up the field. He'll get a gain of at least 20, perhaps more. First and 10 Arizona outside their own 25-yard line. We thought they'd run it, but they didn't.
Well, they threw a screen pass. They didn't throw the ball. They didn't risk throwing it downfield. And here's the screen pass again. There you see John Bell pressuring the quarterback. This is the play that went 94 yards, and for a moment, just a moment, before Douglas catches him, it looked like it might do it again. Wouldn't that have been something to make two 94-yard or 95-yard screen passes in the same game?
Beefs up those statistics as well. Lobos have used a timeout. Again, we remind you about the new Lobo Hotline. For the latest in UNM athletics, call the Lobo Sports Hotline at 277-0644, 24 hours a day. And remember that up and coming will be the Alumni Letterman Annual Hall of Honor Brunch. The brunch is held Sunday, October the 11th, 11:30 a.m. It'll be at the Marriott Hotel. The cost is $20 per person. They'll be inducting Todium, the trainer of the Lobos, into that Alumni Letterman's Hall of Honor, and some others as well. That hotline for Lobo Sports, Gary, is brand new. You can call and get results of cross country, soccer, the whole nine yards.
Yes, it is.
There's Veal, the freshman. He took over. Well, he played quite a bit. Then Waters went out with a bruised hip, and they want to save him for UCLA at UCLA next week. So Veal at his own 25, time running out. Here's Greathouse on a draw, and he'll break tackles and muscle out across the 40-yard line. Another first and 10 for Arizona. And the Lobos will use their last timeout with 1:29 to go in the football game.
This is a draw play leading up the hole now. You see the lineman turn the on-rushing lineman out. Kirk Allen has a hold of him here, but Greathouse is just too strong. That represents the 16th first down for Arizona as compared to 21 first downs for New Mexico.
Greathouse has had some success running the football tonight. 10 carries and 79 yards. And there's tonight's Lobo Metro Mobile Player of the Game. Terrence Mathis probably will lead the country again in all-purpose yardage. Was leading Bobby Humphrey of Alabama coming into tonight's action. And Terrence, I believe, with 167 yards of receptions tonight. Mathis, if he can stay healthy, is going to eclipse just about every receiving and total yardage record that New Mexico and the Western Athletic Conference have ever dreamed of.
And a follow-up on that, Jim. Terrence had a slightly separated shoulder in the middle of last season, missed two games. And to show his toughness, he came back to do what he did last year as a sophomore. And the point is that he's a very durable athlete. So we keep our fingers crossed that we'll see a lot of Terrence Mathis and that he will break those records.
Now the Lobos lose tonight, barring a miracle, 20-9. Mike Shepard will talk with his players next week a lot about learning to win. Taking advantage of the other team's mistakes and cashing in. That's what Arizona did, and that's why they're up by 11. Beal with a little counter to Greathouse. He's got some great room. And finally, will be driven to the ground in Lobo territory at the 48 of New Mexico. 120 and counting remaining in the football game.
At this point, now watch the line play here. There again, it was a trap play. Now the nice hole at the line of scrimmage. The Lobos are looking. They're standing up, looking for who's got the ball. They're anxious to strip the ball from the ball carrier. But I think they're standing up a little bit early, losing their leverage, and the blockers are able to create the holes.
First and 10, Arizona at the Lobo 47-yard line. That's Elridge in motion. This time they send Greathouse up the middle again, and he breaks outside and goes out of bounds, has another first down.
Another trap play.
So the Wildcats chewing up some yardage. This is really, with the exception of the one time when they fumbled, the only time they moved the ball in the second half.
It's their only drive of the second half, you're right. Darren Douglas has had to make a lot of touchdown-saving tackles this year. Usually very reliable.
56 seconds remaining. Ronald Veal, the young quarterback, takes the snap, wheels towards the sideline. He's got room, and he's out of bounds after getting another first and 10 outside the 23 of New Mexico. Why all of a sudden now the Wildcats just churning up the yardage?
Counteraction series. Well, I really think, now let's see if the Lobos are higher than the blockers. Yes, the Lobos are kind of standing up. They're looking for the ball. They want to try to tackle the ball instead of the man, and they're getting moved out.
Brett Eber was a Lobo who rode Ronald Beeler, check that, I should say, the ball carrier, out of bounds. It was Beal. Beal now just backpedals and is dropped for a loss. Looked like you're just running some clock now, Gary, showing a bit of respect for the Lobos and their effort.
Well, I would have been surprised if they had put the ball up in the air that play, but that's what he started out to do. But Brian McCabe got through there, dropping for a loss.
Well, I guess I misread that then. They were looking to get another score.
I really thought that he was retreating to pass. You might have been right, though. He might have been evading a tackle.
You're the coach. Here's the running play. Will not go anywhere. Lobos stack it up. We're down to 5 seconds to go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and the Lobos will lose it here in Tucson. Arizona will run their record to 1 up and 1 down, and the worksheet for the Lobos, nothing up and 3 down. Your final score here tonight, the University of Arizona 20, the University of New Mexico 9. We'll be right back and wrap things up from Tucson. Stay right with us.
We're back at Arizona Stadium in Tucson, Arizona. Gary Ness, along with Jim Lawwill, we're kind of living through the attack of the Killer Moths right now, but the final score, 20-9. And Gary, what can the Lobos gather from this ball game? Obviously, the second half was all theirs. In fact, people up here in the media are saying, hey, you guys really won the second half. Really, probably outplayed Arizona, but the score will not indicate that.
Well, the score is the important thing, but in any loss, I don't care the difference of how much you're favored or whether you're an underdog or what, but any time you lose, you go through the films and you analyze the game, you find situations, well, if we'd have done this or if I'd have done this, and in other words, things that were within our capability we could do, had we done them, we'd have won the game or it would have changed things. And that's always painful to do, but that's what they have to do. They have to eliminate those types of things. But they seem to do the hard work. We talked about maintaining possession. They did that in the first half and ended up on the downside of a 20-0 score.
But they have to fight through frustration, eliminate those things that we were talking about, and they'll beat somebody.
How about BYU next week? They're struggling tonight, perhaps losing. They could come into the game 1-2.
Well, BYU, will the real BYU stand up? Here they come back and beat Texas after that discouraging loss to Pittsburgh. So I don't know how this game tonight with TCU is developing, but BYU certainly showed they have the capability of being a top-notch team.
Well, it should be interesting, and we'll have that game, same-day coverage, 10 p.m. Remember the Mike Shepherd Show tomorrow. Coach Shepherd will be on, and, of course, a feature on Barry Garrison, the Lobo quarterback. The final here tonight, the University of Arizona 20, the New Mexico Lobos 9. Until next week, it will be a University Stadium with the Lobo BYU game. Jim Lawwill, on behalf of Gary Ness, saying so long. Here's hoping that today and every day your team's a winner. The final again was the University of Arizona 20, the New Mexico Lobos 9. We'll see you next time. Be sure to join us.
Lobo football on Channel 14 was brought to you in part by Coors, the beer with a difference worth tasting. Coors is the one. Coors Light, the silver bullet. There's no slowing down with the silver bullet. Ajax Mobile Home. They've got the spirit, and it shows. Safeway, America's favorite food store. And by American Toyota, New Mexico's number one Toyota dealership. Be watching Channel 14 next Saturday night at 10.